called. So I just called them the eye creature.
Oh, okay. Wait, here, I thought...
We are live! Sorry about all the technical issues. Ryan had an emergency.
Yeah.
Wait. We were talking about beholders before we came in. Ryan, what game were you talking about?
Dragon's Dogma.
Sorry, my dogs are barking. Let me go check on that, then we'll get back.
He's gonna have to take his dog to get stitches now.
Yeah.
Hey, how's your brother?
He doesn't know how to play this game because he just doesn't want us to play this game.
Exactly.
Okay, if we are ready to start.
Oh, dude, I was about to say that you're gonna have to go with your dog to get stitches.
Okay, so
what's up with your dog, man?
This game,
there's somebody outside.
Are you sure you're not killing your dog in the background? That's what
she's a beagle. She's a beagle. They're loud.
Oh.
I have a beagle too.
Uncute.
Yeah, when they get going, they don't like stopping. They like to just like. Ow!
They're hunting dogs.
She's a hound beagle. So, we had to take a break as Wings, you went entered the church with the party.
Yes.
So, you noticed the student dead on the altar as he was seemingly used it as cover.
His jumpsuit says he's from Vault 101.
You notice there's bet marks as if there was some sort of fight in this church.
I presumed that. What kind of marks?
Blast marks.
Blast marks? Guys, there's blast marks on this body.
You also notice the body has a book on it.
Here. Say
body
again?
Has what on it?
A book.
A book. I take the book.
Wait, I like books.
It's a log book that he was keeping detailing info of his mission.
Okay, I'm going to read.
If you'll go into the handouts page.
I'm going to flip through it, and then I'm going to get bored, and I'm going to throw it over my shoulder.
If you go into the handouts page, go to the journal, and in handouts, there's just a logbook found on a corpse.
I'll read it out loud.
If one of you could read all that out loud.
Does this guy look like a nerd?
Yes, he looked like a nerd.
You want me to read it?
I ran into an odd cult today. Oh, my gosh. They've been digging up bodies from the graves throughout the meadow. They spotted me, but I fled immediately. Day 3. What happened on day 2?
Yeah, nothing of importance, seemingly.
Nothing of importance. Day 3. I was run out of Oban by a group calling themselves the Devourers.
Uh-oh.
They overrun the city with a large force, but they had these flying one-eyed beings that seemed to be straight from a child's nightmare. I checked to see what happened to the city 3 days ago. They have taken over and shut the gates.
Sounds vaguely Russian.
I heard rumors of the city's prison connecting the old catacombs. I may be able to get in and free whomever survived. He is a nerd. He used the word whomever.
He's from a magic high school. What do you think he is?
Day 4. I checked the catacombs. The entrance was there. I was spotted by guards and fled. Day 4.5. They have been chasing me for 12 hours. They do not seem to rest. I've taken refuge in a church, but I fear they're not far off.
Why did he write day 4.5?
He could have just continued his, He could have just continued day 4.
No, no, he's a nerd.
Wait a second!
What?
Wait a second, it means that he wrote day 4 in between, while he was getting chased.
Exactly.
Day 4.
That's the joke. The joke was, my original idea for the character was you would meet him writing it as he was running away. And screw it, I think it would be funny if we found him dead.
Aww.
We almost met him. I feel connected now. Fear doesn't care. She's immensely bored.
Dumb wizards.
Stupid wizards.
You do notice he has a really nice cloak on, though.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh. And check out that cloak.
It's a cloak that just adds one to AC.
Whoa!
Should probably give that to
Who has
low
AC?
I'm gonna give it to Squishy
McSquisher. What's everyone's AC?
Ooh, I get a cloak!
What's his AC?
I have a 16 AC.
I have a 16. I forget how to calculate.
I have a 15.
Dex. It's just your dex modifier for you, I believe.
For me, one? What?
10 plus 11?
Oh, a plus 1.
His AC is 11, so yes, give it to Squisher.
Yeah. Oh, AC, I thought you said did.
So now your AC is 12.
Yeah.
This is called the Cloak of Protection, fairly simple, and it's just a black cloak with a... It has like a... What's that type of thing where like you take... I forget the word for it. Never mind. It's
Why don't you describe it?
Hood?
No.
A bucket?
Why don't you describe it?
You know when you take a bunch of thread, like you take a bunch of thread and you make a design with the thread in the clothing itself?
Embroidered.
There's just a shield embroidered on it.
Aww. That's cute. Like on the back?
Yeah.
Oh, it's been bedazzled. I'll definitely give it to Quip.
Yeah. Ah, fuck. Oh, my chair.
It's a plus 1 to AC and a plus 5 to getting killed by beholders.
Mm-hmm. So what this cloak simply puts, it's just a plus 1 fiction, but what this book is telling you is that the cult you guys ran into the other day has taken over the town of Oban.
That's awful.
Doesn't matter. I have a cloak.
I know
We'll just throw Quip at him.
They gave me this weird scar.
I have a cloak.
Need to find out more about them.
Yeah.
Jack catches up at this point and says, Oban, we were supposed to head there.
Oh, hey, oh, Jack.
Where'd you come from?
He stayed back because of the things you guys saw. He said that.
Oh, right.
He said he'd come by
awkward.
When things went.
Scared me there, Jack.
I was only hired to take you to Oban itself.
Right.
Are
we in Oban?
You guys are about 2 hours away from Oban on foot.
All right.
You can walk 2 hours. All right, Jack.
I'm gonna... If Oban's fallen, I'm gonna head back to the necropolis.
Oh my gosh.
My computer's getting
powered. Jack.
But the tears...
What the
hell?
Seriously, if you're too much of a coward, that's fine.
Either way, I'm gonna... Here, I'll make a deal with you. I'll stay... I don't know.
Just go back. I don't think
How about you take this, and I'm gonna pick up the body and just, like, dump it in his arms?
Should I use Charm Person on him?
Oh, I'll take this back to the town.
Yeah, and find his family, make sure he gets buried, you know, honorable rites, so that he doesn't come back as a spooky ghost.
Spooky. Like Casper?
Yeah.
So, you guys know that your goal is the city beyond Oban. It's where you're supposed to meet up to get to the living city. You do not have to go there, but one of your other side objectives was to investigate this cult's connection to these creatures appearing.
What do you think, Jack?
I'm going to Oban. I need to find out more about what happened to me.
I don't think we should go to Oban.
Don't?
No.
What does Palila think?
Sarah apparently's computer shut off for some reason.
I think she said something along the lines of running out of battery or something.
Think that Oban's a pretty dangerous place, and I think we should avoid it.
What's the worst that could happen? Get attacked by a beholder?
Yeah.
I don't know what that is, but it doesn't sound too tough.
It probably won't happen.
Well, but I mean, there's cults.
I'm sure we can handle it. Don't you want to get stronger, Quip?
Yeah. We gave you a cloak. You'll be fine.
Yeah.
Wait. Should I use Charm Person on you too?
I don't know if you can do that to both
of
us.
I can. She has advantage on it.
I do have advantage on it.
Shit, yeah.
Let me just add you guys a role-playing pulp stats for something other than a beholder.
Okay. Sorry, that was loud. Oh, what challenge rating is Beholder?
Depends which one I'm using. Because it's not a spectator.
It's true. Holy crap. What is wrong with you?
What? Which
what?
One?
Challenge rating of 13?
Oh. Yeah, sure.
No.
Is that the next highest one?
Now, what she doesn't know is there's a beholder between that one and the spectator that's not with the beholders.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, I don't know why it's not there, but...
Oh! I know where it is.
Stop looking at monsters!
Oh, come on. Man. Wow.
I know. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll stop.
Come back.
You promise?
I'll stop. I threw it across the room. It's fine.
The page.
It's the exact same thing I tell him not to do, but it's so tempting.
I know, because it's like, ooh, I want to see what we're finding.
I know.
Hey, Sarah,
back.
Your computer hands on.
Sarah's back.
I think that, okay, now we can decide if we want to go to open.
All right. Okay, so here's the deal, Palilla. Okay? Can you hear me?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Here's the deal. Oben's been taken over by the cult. We don't have to go there, but Jack wants to. Quip doesn't want to because he's a coward.
Because there's eye creatures.
Now Quip's, you know, doubts are well founded, but I think we should go anyway.
Yeah.
Why do we have to care about a cult?
You know what?
Because my thing. I have a thing.
What thing?
There's a giant scar on my shoulder that connects me to something.
I broke the staff, so there's no reason for us to go there.
We should still find out as much as we can.
Yeah.
Don't make me break the wand as well.
What wand?
The wand I got from the staff.
What?
He broke the staff. The cane. Half of it was kept working. So it's now just a casting implement.
Yeah.
Using like, a plus two or something?
Plus one.
I'm going to stab you with it and you'll die.
I don't think it works like that anymore.
Well, we don't know. Do we?
I don't think that Quip should be going against the party because that's bad and we could all kill
him. That's how you lost your two other characters.
God damn it. I'm trying to have a...
And I think that this time, Palilla is going to give him a warning and say that going against the party and being ridiculous is bad, and I'm going to warn you before you do it.
Okay, let's have a
joke. And, like, Tyr has already threatened that if Jack dies, regardless of whether or not he was involved, she's going to kill Quip. Mm.
Okay. Let's have a vote to see who wants to go into open. I raised my hand to say I don't want to go into open.
Well, Kraken, that seems like a good replacement for the Beholder.
He wants... Come on.
All right, Tyr, what's your vote?
Okay, you two... who wants to go to open?
What'd you say?
Who wants to go to open?
All right.
Uh-huh.
Jack is going to pull out his sword and raise it above his head and say, I vote to go to Oben.
Oh, cool. Tyr's totally into this. She pulls out two swords and does it.
Well, I guess that means it's up to me.
Yes.
But I
have two swords.
I don't, care if we go or not, but I'm a little scared to go against Jack and Tyr. I'm not, scared.
You're not scared to go up against a giant cult.
I don't know. I kind of can relate to people that have to deal with cults.
Because of weirdos.
I wouldn't mind skipping over it, but, I feel like we were doing the right thing by trying to get rid of the cult.
Okay, you know what? As soon as we get to Owen, I'm casting invisibility. I'm just going to follow you people.
Follow
us? That's a good call. Okay,
That's what's going to happen. You're not going to see...
Wait, so we're going into open, but you're casting invisibility?
On myself.
On yourself? Well, you like using your tricksy, cheaty magic stuff. why don't we try things your way, starting out? And then when things inevitably go wrong, we'll run in swords blazing.
Okay. Well, I think that we should take a rest before we go to open at the very least.
Okay.
Well, that's fair.
A good idea.
Fair enough.
A very long rest.
Okay. Well, you guys want a long rest? Take it, nerds.
Yeah.
I'll take first watch.
Yep.
I'm going to sleep in the church.
Okay, well, you just meditate, so you can take all watches. Who's going to take watches? Just that person have me roll a perception check for me.
I'm going to sit on the altar and sharpen my sword all night.
Did we check the light that was coming in out from the church?
It stopped before we got in here.
Oh, I forget.
You guys are jerks. I'm not going to use the monster I had planned now.
Boo-hoo,
Brent.
Poor Brent.
Poor Brent.
There you go.
I hate What did you get?
Oh, should I be rolling a second check?
Roll a perception check.
Okay, sorry. You didn't say anything about that, so I was just
yeah,
sort of like,
I did.
Well...
Yeah,
oh,
I did.
Shoot, crap. I wasn't paying attention, I was just being... Alright, here we go. Alright, you ready?
No.
Alright, here we go. Skills. Perception. Blam!
What
I
is
got
it?
12.
12? Okay, so you don't notice anything on your shift, but then you
awesome.
Have to take your 4 hours, so somebody else give me to takes a shift.
I'll do it.
Okay.
Dude,
give me a perception.
Be aware
do a perception check. All right.
Oh, yeah, you're aware, so you can give me another one, too.
Yay. I noticed nothing.
All right, now it's my turn.
Okay, so now, let's say, so now, Talon, give me a perception check.
12.
So, you guys wake up, and Talon...
Yeah?
You notice your shoes untied.
I tie my shoes.
Okay.
Suspiciously.
Good thing you tied that shoe.
Actually, no. I'm going to take my shoes off and inspect them.
Your shoe's perfectly fine. You just left it untied when you went to bed.
Why are you looking at your shoes? Because they were untied.
Why do you sleep with your shoes on, weirdo?
There's something like... Oh, wait. Hold on.
Could have been Smurf Nebula.
Here, you guys can see your characters now.
Oh, I need to change some things around.
Everybody's fully healed.
Do I have
got a better monster?
My full health is back, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. What happened?
So, you guys are on. Gonna head to Oban?
I suppose.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yep.
Yeah, I better have a plan.
You guys
aren't we gonna do things?
You know, Oban is a walled city. This its wall is known for just being nearly impossible to get through.
Okay.
Siege things have gone across this before, but you have heard from that book that apparently the catacombs connect to it. Which catacomb, though, is the question? There's tons here, but it's probably one of the ones by the outskirts of the city.
Hey, Brent.
Mm-hmm.
While I was trancing, can that special third spell that I didn't tell anyone about have accidentally...
I can't hear you. Sarah, mute yourself. Thank you. What was that, Wings? Oh, the third spell?
Yeah.
Yeah. You wait. There's a dragon on Wings.
What?
There's a small, looks like to be a newborn dragon on top of Tyr.
Why?
Just nibbling on her hair.
Why is there a dragon on Tyr?
Why'd you get a dragon?
Huh?
Tyr, how did you get a dragon?
A what?
Give me a perception check, Tyr.
Amazing. 20.
You notice there's a dragon nibbling on your hair.
Oh my gosh, there's a dragon nibbling on my hair.
Okay.
Roll initiative.
I'm gonna pick it up by the scruff.
You hear the words in your head. You just feel the emotion of
like discontent.
Like irritation, discontent.
Oh, I'm gonna put it down on the altar.
You feel, it looks at the body. Wait, no, the body's gone, shit.
Yeah, the body's gone.
Yeah.
It just looks at you all.
Huh.
Did you summon it accidentally or something?
I'm gonna check my bag for that familiar stone.
It's not there.
I think this is my familiar.
Yeah.
I'm gonna poke it.
It's kind of cute.
I think so too.
Give me a deck save, Jack.
You're struggling to say our character's name, aren't you?
I was gonna say, dude, your real name's a character name. I'm sorry.
It's true. It literally is. I told you, right?
Yeah.
And his character name's a real name.
Yeah.
What'd you 11. Get?
Got an 11.
Take 1 fire damage. It's gonna spit a little fireball at you.
Oh no! I like him. I'll put out an arm.
It goes on your shoulder, but it continues. But you still hear the continues. Just the emotion of all right.
Mm-hmm. He's awesome.
So you guys said you needed a plan for Oven.
Yeah, what are we gonna do things Quips way?
I can only cast invisibility on myself.
Well, you can scout ahead.
Oh, that's a good idea. Okay, I'm going to use invisibility along with my meta magic of extend spell.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so, you got an invisible?
So I go invisible for 24 hours. At the
wow.
For the cost of 1 sorcerer point and 1 level 2 spell slot.
But the second you do interact with stuff or cast a new spell, it goes away, doesn't it?
Yep.
So, yeah, do you? I'm guessing you go and scout out Oben?
Yep.
So you look around. You notice that there's a weird stone mound in front of each entrance.
What type of mound?
It's a weird rock.
Is it like a baseball mound?
It's like a huge rock.
A rock?
It doesn't look like a human could have put it there.
I guess I'm going to try and sneak around them.
Well, you'd successfully sneak around them. You also notice that on the wall are members wearing the same cloak you saw the cult members that attacked you guys wearing.
Uh-huh.
And you hear moaning from inside the walls.
Is there anywhere I can see or can get into the walls?
You don't notice any weak point in the walls, but you do notice a couple open catacombs, specifically one near the entrance near the prison.
Okay, I'm going to go check that out.
You find inside is a stairwell going down.
Just down?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to go down.
You find yourself in a catacomb. There's bodies on the walls, and it just keeps going further to down. It's very wide.
I guess I'll keep on following the catacombs down.
You come across the point where there's a break in the wall leading into a room that has a different building way, just bricks instead of catacombs and bodies.
I'm going to go check out that room.
As you check out the room, you notice it's a torture chamber. It looks fairly modern.
Is there anyone in the torture chamber?
There's a couple corpses, but that's about it.
Is there any doors?
Yes, there is. There's a wooden door.
Is it open?
It's unlocked.
What, if I open it, would that break the spell?
No, I'm going to say no.
Okay, then I'm going to open it.
You find yourself in what looks like a bunch of cells. It's a wing full of just cells.
Is there anyone in the cells, or is it all empty?
It's, you notice one person.
I'm gonna go up to that person and whisper. They're in a cell, right?
Mm-hmm. You notice they're wearing fairly regal clothing.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna walk up to the cell and say hello. I'm still invisible.
Hello? Oh, where are you?
Don't worry where I am. Why are you in there?
They put me in here.
For what?
The hostage.
Who are you?
The nobility of the city. I was the regent.
The regent?
Jane Fairweather is my name.
Oh, it's a chick.
No, it's a dude.
What?
Oh.
Jane Fairweather.
His name is Jane.
Not very masculine.
The relation to Jacqueline Fairweather?
Jacqueline.
Another dude with a chick name?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I'm sorry, I haven't... I'm kind of tired. What are you doing here? How did you...
Like, J-A-I-N?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh. I was gonna
Yeah. I thought he meant, like, J-A-N-E, and I was like, what?
Yep.
What do you want?
I want to know a way to go past the city.
Go past the city?
Yes.
Just go for the graveyard. It's kind of dangerous. You don't know what might pop up, but you don't have to go for the city. It's kind of easy. There's other roads.
Is there any monsters in the graveyard?
Normally no, but with the beast these things had with them, I'd expect yes.
Would there be a holder there?
Holder?
A beholder?
Why would you hold a bee?
You know. Reason.
Oh, the eye thingies. I've read about them. They were released in the main street, and their job was to massacre as many people as they could.
Oh, sounds fun.
Sounds like my kind of job.
Yeah.
Then there were the golems. They put themselves in the city gates before we could close them. So there was no way to stop the force.
Okay.
So during certain times of the day, they're active and do patrols. You can hear their stomping.
Now, I'm going to ask him if he wants me to put him out of his misery.
His eyes just go wide. Why?
Well, there's no way you're ever escaping from this place. So do you just want to end it all?
How did you get in? You could just take me out.
Yeah, but there's nothing in it for me.
I'm sure he could take you out. That's exactly what he wants to do.
What's it for me?
Well, if you're gonna put me out of my misery, it would probably break your spell.
What would you give me if I got you out of here?
My thanks? Besides the clothing and skin on my back, I don't really have much right now.
I mean, I'm sure there's someone else I can see for more.
They've been killing most of the people. I'm really only here as a hostage.
Why?
I was the leader of Oben.
Oh, yeah.
I'm worth quite a bit.
Now, if I took you hostage, how much do you think I could get for you?
I can't put a price on my own life.
Now, this is the point where I feel like I should take him, just because he's probably worth a lot of money.
You're a strange fellow.
Okay, I'm gonna take him.
The cell's locked.
Oh, shit. Oh, I know. I can come back with my party and they can bust open the gate because there's some brutes in the party, and that's all. They're good smashing stuff.
Brutes, and their names are Palilla and Tyr.
Brute 1 and Brute 2. And then, then you'll be our hostage.
Is that much better?
Well, we won't rape you.
These people aren't doing that either.
In fact, those people didn't even mention it, so it's a little...
I can tell that you've been tossed around the barracks a couple times.
What are you insinuating? Guards!
No! Oh, I'm invisible.
They just come right by, shut up, old man. Okay. And they go away.
Okay.
Now,
I can't convince them or anything.
Okay. I can promise that I won't rape you, but Thing 1 and Thing 2 may.
Is this an intimidation check?
Yeah.
Roll intimidation.
Mm.
Also, I'm not really a big fan of these type of jokes, Ryan, just for your info.
Okay. Okay. Oh.
What'd you get?
A 4.
Can you leave me alone?
Okay. I'm just gonna go back to the party and go all the way to get into this.
Alright, while he's gone, I'll do story Jack.
You what? I can't really hear you.
While he's gone, I'll be sparring with Jack.
Oh, alright.
And by sparring, you mean you're giving Jack a noogie.
Yeah, and by sparring, I mean it starts with like harmless violence that goes a little too far.
What is your damage tier? Why are you giving me a noogie?
I don't know, I just feel like it.
I'm gonna...
Quip isn't here.
That does it to me a lot.
You feel like toss her over my back.
Okay.
Oh, Brett does that to me too.
She's really light. I can just swing her at people like a weapon.
He doesn't usually go that far.
I've done it a couple times.
Just like twice.
So that probably goes on for a while.
Mm-hmm. So, Quip, you get back to them sparring.
Mm-hmm.
What is Palilla doing? Palilla?
You're not asking me, are you?
What?
What are you doing during this time?
Oh, I guess I'm kind of watching them, making some fresh arrows from, like, sticks and stuff.
Can Arcus interact with her?
Yeah. He just goes over and sits by her. She's quieter than the other two.
I don't know, maybe I, like, fly up and see what I can see, but, like, don't go high enough if they can see me from the city.
You notice that these giant stone rocks have begun to take a more sentient shape with arms and legs, and they're just patrolling around the outskirts of the city.
Great. I go down and I tell the others this.
About this time, Quip comes back.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I tell them about the old man and how we can get the ransom for him.
Oh, holy crap. Quip is back.
Yeah.
Sorry. Startled me. You're invisible.
Oh, yeah. Don't worry about it. I just don't trust you people.
I'm gonna throw Jack at him.
You don't trust your party?
You can't throw me.
Oh,
I'm just gonna let you throw me.
Give me a strength check.
No, but I'm gonna keep the invisibility up because I don't want to waste.
Athletics?
Mm-hmm. Athletics.
Okay.
Now give me
what do you want?
Give me an athletics check, Jack.
Yeah!
You get frown.
Whee!
Darn it.
So I think you guys should come up with your plan.
Okay.
Yep.
I think that we should go through the catacombs, the the way that I went and get that old man.
What old man?
That old man. The leader of the city.
Oh, they have the leader of the city.
Yeah.
Oh, you're right. We could rescue him.
Yep. What good would that do us, though?
We can ran through him.
That's what Puddlesworth would want.
Excuse me?
We can ransom him.
Oh, Puddlesworth, he was my old teacher. He died under suspicious circumstances. My family probably killed him, you know.
All right, fine. But did you find, like, where the cult people were? Or
they're all over the city.
Oh.
It seems like they made it into a fort.
Yeah.
Do you think we could do any kind of damage here?
You guys probably could. The mass amount of the cult themselves you could probably take. The only issue is the things on the roads patrolling the thing. These monstrous beasts. Beholders, golems. From what you guys have seen.
From the sounds of things, straight through the city might be the safest.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the type of thing where if you guys do this stealthily, you could take out the people making these things alive before they cause damage. And that was just the torture cell of the prison. There's also a massive other wing with more civilian areas.
Can he make anyone invisible aside from himself?
I think I can.
Well, you can?
Well, let me check. I'm not exactly sure. Touch.
Yeah, you can do it.
Yeah. But it would only last for 1 hour unless I use a sorcerer.
And you can only do one person at a time.
All right.
Well,
it's a concentration spell.
Yeah.
Do we want to try and stealth this?
But
I don't know.
Who would be the best person for the spell to affect?
Probably the dex-based character.
So skill challenge.
Yeah,
me and Tyr aren't really the stealthy type.
But that
would
really only be a thing that happens when you get to the city. It's you now that the monsters are patrolling around. It won't be as easy to get in to the catacombs now.
Oh, really?
Why?
Those beasts, the giant rocks, have grown humanoid and start patrolling.
Oh.
Apparently, they have a recharge thing.
Can't we wait until they're done?
Yeah.
We're on time constraint, though. There's a giant ticking clock coming out of the sea.
Out of the mountains, but yeah, the terrace is about 2 days off. If you wait too long, the thing will attack the city. You're not sure how long Necropolis can hold. And if it falls, Oben's right in the path to the Yeager cell, which is the beast's skull.
Huh. So, how long would it take to completely skip all the monsters?
You mean just leave Oben?
Yeah. Go around it.
Well, you guys have the horses. You'd make good time. You'd be on track with your journey. You guys could just skip this and leave.
You'd probably
have to deal with a couple of them just on the way out. They're patrolling for the metal themselves.
Could we take care of this on our way back, possibly? Odds
are on the way back. Either the cult will be so the cult's new here. That's why these entrances are still there. It would need a lot more force, and they probably have more members and more monsters by the time you come back. That, or if the terrace takes, there's a couple paths the terrace could take after Necropolis. If it takes the one through Oben will just be a horrible mound of nothing.
You know, it occurs to me that my brother's out here somewhere trying to get a hold of this artifact, and I have reason to believe that this artifact could turn the founder into a god. I really don't want my brother becoming a god.
Can I find it?
I really don't want my brother or Quip becoming a god.
Can I become a god?
What about me?
Who do you want to become a god?
I
kind of want to become a god.
I don't want you to be a god.
I can take it a little.
You don't deserve to be a god.
What would Puddlesworth say? Something not worthy, blah, blah, blah. Mortals are intended to be mortals, blah, blah, blah.
By this point, you do notice that some of the beasts stay by the walls. Some of the others go throughout the meadow. just walking around. It's be risky even staying in the church for too long.
I'm invisible, though.
You guys can continue roleplaying, just that information you guys should know.
Okay.
Am I still invisible, Brent?
Yes.
Okay.
How long would you suspect this entire operation to take?
Depends on you guys.
Well,
With how these type of spells work, I'm going to give you estimations. Taking out if you take out a person who's responsible for keeping these monsters connected to the world, they're gone. It could be an item doing this. It could be a person. If it's a person, they'd have to be some strong higher up to have this much magic. So yeah. There's probably one leader or one object held securely.
I'm just going to bring up the fact that if we do get caught and something does happen to us, if we get captured, we're going to be right. We may be in the monster's path.
You also have to remember that there's probably a large amount of civilians being kept captive right now and there.
Probably.
This was a city.
Is the Tarrasque gonna like wreck everything?
So think of it like this: the necropolis is a definite for where it will go to, but after necropolis, there's a couple other options.
It might just go straight.
It might just not ignore the meadow. It might go to a different area.
It might wreck everything, right?
Yeah, there's a chance it will come through here. There's also a chance that maybe these people are setting up a defense against it. Don't know. Yeah.
Maybe they're going to try and control it.
Maybe.
And that'd be scarier than if... That'd be pretty scary as well. Somebody controlling the god beast.
Alright, I definitely think we should go in there.
Alright, well, whatever we do here, we have to do it fast.
Alright. Let's take a vote.
Again?
Yeah. You and your votes, Quip.
I'm a democratic patriot.
Quip, it has a point, though. Let's be real here.
I recognize that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Now Tears had time to think. You know, so...
I think that it's more important to get to Yggdrasild.
What would our goal here be, Jack? What would satisfy you here?
Free all the civilians and find out more about this thing on my shoulder. And, I don't know, just stop the cult from doing anything.
But what if they have no information?
Well, we still freed a bunch of people.
Yeah, but someone could die.
Yeah, them.
We could die.
You might die.
Just another thing to keep in consideration. With the amount of beasts out throughout the meadow itself, your odds are, even if you continue onward, you'll run to at least one. You'll run into more in the city, but you're going to probably have to cross paths with one.
What do you think, Palilla?
I don't really care.
So non-committal.
Yeah, I just kind of didn't want to get killed the other way. So,
I think that we should go get the old guy and ransom him from a bunch of money.
To who?
To the god beast.
The god beast just carries around 40k on him at all times.
Alright, I just totally disregard Quip and everything he says in this conversation, because I'm not ransoming anything to a god beast who is probably not even a rational thinking being who wants an old dude.
Do we even know what the old...
Oh no, the Tarrasque is a rational thinking being.
Yeah.
It has emotions, it has a mind. It's a higher being is the issue here.
It's probably just misunderstood.
No, it is not a person, it's a higher being.
Oh, can we charm higher being?
Yeah. No. It's the type of thing where it's more along the lines of it's closer to gods than anything living. It's what called the God Beast because it was created from the remains of a dead deity.
But what if I rolled a 20?
So, city is filled with monsters. City is surrounded by monsters. I can't see us liberating the city with enough time to continue our quest.
Yeah, I think our quest needs to kind of take priority.
I've got two time clocks, okay? Like, I've got one brother who's not a jerk who's probably going to get killed by a monster, and one brother who is a jerk who's about to go become a god. Like...
Oh, I know what we should do. We should go after Tyr's brother, get the item, and use that to kill the god beast.
Yeah, that's the plan.
Who wants to give me a history check?
I do.
Except Tyr.
Aww.
What is it? Like, what's
intelligence?
Just about the whole idea about becoming a god.
I will.
I'm going to do a history check.
Or roll. That's the highest intelligence.
Honestly?
History. 6.
Honestly, it's probably me.
I'll do it.
Fine.
Why not?
So, Quip, you get the... Just everybody give me one. Quip, yeah. You get the idea of... Yeah, that's neat. I want to be a god. Jack, you get the idea of...
I'm really hungry.
God? What's a god? And...
That's a cleric!
Mike, I'm not usual, sorry, but I don't know that, so.
Wait, what do I roll?
Give me a history check.
You just roll a d20 if you want, and then...
Okay.
Why can't Tyr roll for it?
Because she probably already knows.
Yeah, this is info Tyr would have.
Oh. Why doesn't she just tell us, then?
Yeah.
Because didn't I say it earlier?
Okay, so yeah, Palila, you would know that you don't just become a god. There's a chain and steps. The first step is you need something to grant you the title of blank. This is somebody who's more akin of a demigod. It doesn't grant you anything but the ire of the current ones. It's more along the lines of the first step, your blank card. To become a true god, you need to become blank. Then you need to gain a domain through being gifted one from a god with two. Overthrowing a god, or creating a domain through some legendary feat, unfathomable to most humans.
In other words, you're one great big target.
Yeah.
That's a risk I'm willing to take.
Good.
Yeah. So, what's the plan here?
Yeah, what is
that? Jack is just going to sullenly like look down his boots, sheathe his sword, and be like, fine, we can go after your Grassel.
I mean, I like the guy. He's a pretty swell guy.
Who do you like?
Your brother.
Which one?
The one that wants to become a god.
No.
Gosh.
He's a huge jerk.
He is a huge jerk.
You know, in the book club,
that is in character, by the way. Jack just chimes in and says he is a huge jerk.
Oh, you haven't been to the book club. He's a pretty insightful guy.
Nerd.
I've met him.
I just want to become a god more than I like him.
So you guys skipping Oban?
Yeah, I think that's
okay.
Fine.
So are you just embarking now?
Yeah, we're going to go after
him. Yeah, we're gonna be quick. Summon the horses.
So it is now time for a skill challenge.
The last thing I said was nerd, so the horse is nerd.
Okay, so let's keep it simple.
Skill challenge, can I get ice cream?
Yeah, everybody take a break. Let's keep it simple.
Yeah,
you need 8 wins, victories to win, and you only have, let's say, 4 losses.
Oh, no.
Actually, let's say, one, 4 losses, 1 for each.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, I'll be right back. I'm going to go get some food.
Same.
I'm gonna go drink something. All right. Do-do-do.
Yo.
Hey.
My computer's not laggy anymore. It's great.
That's good.
My computer's really fickle. I just have to restart it a bunch until I get lucky, and then there's no lag.
I can tell. Jack is not happy about having to leave Oven.
I wouldn't blame him. You think about it, though. These things, these people definitely know about the God Beast and would know he might come through here. They're probably setting up a defense.
True.
They probably
they all brought up really good points, which is the only reason he was just like, fine. But mm-hmm. You see, he's not happy about it.
That was a fun discussion.
I'm naming my horse Borak.
Wonderful.
It means lightning in Arabic.
Nice.
So. I thought that was appropriate considering things. Yeah. And I also got my spells for being a third level Tempest Domain. Mm-hmm. So Shatter, if I use my Channel Divinity, is just going to be an automatic 24 damage to everyone.
Is that a second level or third level?
It's a second level. No, gotcha. I'm level 3 cleric. So I get two more spells in the Tempest Domain. So basically, if I use my Channel Divinity, I can get 24 damage automatically in a 10-foot radius sphere. So that's going to be useful, hopefully. Yeah.
So odds are still that you're going to have to fight one of the giant beasts, or escape one.
Yeah, it's fine. Hopefully fight it. I'm going to fight it.
Ooh. Well, I'm thinking the skill challenge is going to decide whether you have to fight or not.
Oh, it is? All right. Fair enough. I wish we had ice cream.
How are you, Talon?
Okay. Wasn't really in the mood for playing D&D when we started, but I'm getting into it now.
Yeah, just one of those days.
Yeah, but I'm feeling fine now. I'm enjoying it.
Good.
Hello.
Hey. One of my favorite things when looking at the monsters, dude, is to look at the amount of hit dice they get. Like, a hit dice is pretty much the equivalent of one level, so you can sort of guess what level these guys would be if they were players. It's fun.
You still got nothing.
Me?
Yeah. Okay, now I can hear you a little bit.
Oh, well, you're not able to hear me?
No.
Not about my hit dice thing?
Nope.
When you look at monsters, it tells you how much hit dice they have, and you generally get one hit dice per level, so you can sort of guess their level if they were players.
Oh, okay.
Like, what I'm going to be throwing at you has 12 hit dice.
Oh, okay, maybe we shouldn't fight it then.
No, you guys can take it.
Oh, we can.
The thing about D&D is, look at the werewolf. I had to make it move twice, otherwise it would have been slaughtered for you, right?
Right.
As long as you outnumber the enemy, specifically with as much as you get, you can slaughter them generally, as long as your rolls are on par.
Right.
Spamming stuns, just bursting damage.
Yeah.
Like, what? Levels aren't as reliable, and CRs aren't that reliable, specifically in player favor. I'm playing a Pathfinder game where a character metagamed his character to the point where he can do 300 damage per turn.
Oh, wow.
Average enemies have about 100 health. Or 60 health right now at level 11.
Brent.
Yeah?
What is the God Beast? I'm not exactly sure.
It's a Tarrasque.
Oh.
You know what those are?
Nope.
It's the strongest thing in the Monster Manual.
Oh.
It's literally a level 30 enemy, and the max level in the game is level 20.
How do you spell it?
I'll get up the exact spelling for you. T-A-R-A.
T-A-R-A.
A-S-Q-U-E.
A-S-Q-U-E.
This is a Tarrasque.
Jesus, that is scary.
Yeah.
They're oh, wow. Insane. That's big and scary looking.
Oh,
that's a lot of horns, too.
Said to exist in each world.
It is really big.
The idea is one world can only support one of these things due to how dangerous they are. If two were to exist, the world would just be destroyed with how much they consume and destroy.
Well, Tarrasque, so you absolutely, positively have to kill every motherfucker in your campaign.
Yep, that's generally what Tarrasques are used for. Guess which party members are googling Tarrasques?
Tarrasque?
Yeah.
Flying Tarrasque, and you fifth level wizard just thought you were safe.
Wait. The thing is, it says it has a low intelligence and cannot speak.
Because it's a beast.
Then why did you say that can be reasoned with earlier, Brent?
Yeah, I said it can't be reasonless because it's a higher being, but Tarrasque in the book are not necessarily the Tarrasque I am using.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm allowed to change things. In this game, in this setting, the Tarrasque isn't some horribly strong beast. It's literally the child of a god who wanted to create nothing but monsters. He created one for each of the realms. The sea, he created two for the sea, one for the air, and one for the earth.
Was it Echidna?
With their four heads. We ready to start?
Mm-hmm.
Are we?
Okay, so the skill challenge is, as you guys are moving on forward, you've noticed you've gotten the attention of a large earth elemental. And it is following you all.
Oh, are we on horseback or are we walking?
It's sort of hard to be on horseback with all the graves.
Oh, yeah.
So you are walking, but this thing is just running after you, smashing graves in your way. Your goal is to get away from it. You need 8 wins and you have 4 losses.
Okay.
Let's start off. Everybody roll initiative.
Initiative plus dexterity.
All right, I have a 10, so I'll just put that in.
Seven.
Whenever I try to roll initiative using my character sheet, it always just says, like, the token isn't there or something.
Oh. Yeah, you have to click on your token.
Yep. Oh, okay. I did not
know. And your token has to be attached to your character. Like, the DM has to go in there and say, this token represents this character.
I understand.
Wait, that guy got all. Okay, so is Palila roll initiative? Oh, 7.
I did.
Wow, you guys got really low. Lucky the thing got lower.
Oh God, what did you get? 1.
You got a 2.
Whew.
So Jack, you're going to start us up. This thing is chasing you guys. What do you do?
Let's see, don't know what I do. Does it think at all, or is it just like a mindless beast? Like,
it thinks a bit, but it's obviously controlled by something.
Oh, so I can't like use thaumaturgy to try and intimidate it or anything?
It's not some. If you look at its size, you're not. If it's like an earthquake, you're pretty sure it would think it's making the earthquake.
Okay, I don't really know what to do against something like this.
Running is an option.
Yeah, you guys just want to run.
I guess I'll just run then. Roll athletics or something?
Mm-hmm. Roll athletics.
We all get one reroll, right?
One reroll for the party. That is a failure.
Party?
Yep.
Wow.
Would you like to reroll?
You think I should reroll or just...
No.
A loss is a loss.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, so it's
oh,
I'm like...
So oh, was it a one?
Like, no, if you losing one and her losing one is always going to be the same, so re-rolling just really, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, do it doesn't if you want. Matter when you re-roll. Just do it.
So should I re-roll?
Yeah.
Like, mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah. There we go.
Success. No re-roll now.
Okay.
It is now Palila's turn. Jack is running, so you cannot use athletics this turn.
Oh, sorry. I think it's fine. I'm gonna, what do I even do? Right, he's running, so I guess it wouldn't be much point in fighting it, so.
Well, you can, like, throw arrows at it.
Now, you also have to be careful of not drawing the attention of a second one.
Right.
True.
One of these things you might be able to handle. Two of these things
so,
are dead.
Like, you could.
Can I do a stealth check to try to fly away stealthily?
Sure. Abandon the party. Go ahead.
No,
well, to keep
fly away.
Attracting a second.
After Jack, but.
Okay, roll it.
Wait, what's stealth?
Dex plus 2, I think. So, should be 15. 5. Plus 5.
Alright. This little 20 is so slow.
Are great for fighters, let me tell you.
I'm hitting it. It's not going through.
Stop hitting it. You're making it slower.
Yeah.
No, I'm trying to open the box to hit the
button. Oh, I'll just roll a d20 and add 5 for it, you.
No, I have a d20.
Fine, roll it yourself.
I mean,
I got an 11.
His...
Plus 5, 16.
Success! Okay.
Okay, I stealthily fly off.
Quick, you're up.
I'll stay close to the party.
Quip.
Ryan.
Yeah?
It's your turn.
Is it?
Answer by your character name, damn it.
This it's weird.
That's how you play the game.
Strange.
And it's funny because he actually uses my actual name whenever he's talking about Tyr.
Shut up.
Okay.
What are you doing? Palila's flying. You cannot use stealth. Palila is hiding and flying. Jack is running. There's a large stone mass chasing after you.
Yeah. Can I use perception?
What for what?
To see how the stone... To see the best way to get around.
Sure. Roll it.
Yay.
Fail.
What? A 15?
That's the DC.
Oh, are you kidding?
Wow, really?
Yeah. This thing's going to be hard to get away from, guys. I mean, there's tons of them, and getting away from one might land you into the jaws of another. There's graves everywhere. It's hard to trip up. I mean, most of your skills are going to be plus 5 anyway, so this is basically get a 10 or get it higher than a 10.
My highest skill is a plus 4.
Well, that's rough for you. Speaking of which tier, you're up.
Yay!
You cannot use perception.
Okay, I'm going to use athletics.
Okay.
I'm going to pick up a rock and throw it at him. And keep running. Actually, I'm going to pick up an entire gravestone.
Okay.
17.
Now, what's the rule for if something realistically wouldn't have an effect on the thing?
It's mostly just to kind of, like, distract it.
Gotcha, I see. So that will be a success.
I'm not trying to kill it. I am trying to kill it, but I recognize that I'm not going to.
Now it is the beast's turn.
All right.
So let's see. Let me just bring up the chart for its checks. What you add to this level's monster's checks. I should have had that up. I apologize.
No worries, man.
So, challenge really plus 3. So this will be, he is going to make a strength check just to try and slow all you down and just rattle the earth underneath you.
I'm flying.
So this will be a 23. All of you make a con save.
I am not on the ground.
Okay, you succeed. Now, all of you make a con save to try and beat 23.
Are you serious?
Are you?
A nat 20 would succeed this.
I don't.
Oh! Oh! Quip!
Ty goes really? The player.
So, Quip Ty goes it? The player. So, that's 2-2. You know what? I'm just going to roll a d4 to decide what happens now. low, he wins. So that's a loss. High, you guys win. Low, he won.
What?
Because it was a tie between 2-1, 2 failed.
So does that count as a fail?
Yep.
No! This thing's gonna murder us.
So now it is Jack's turn.
Alright,
kill it, Jack.
Kill it with fire.
Can I...
Like,
you cannot use athletics.
Can I try and use my spirit horse and then try to use animal handling to try and like navigate around
the... Is that
the...
a thing in this edition? Yeah, it is. sure, go ahead.
I have to shout its name first, right? The first
what
time
is its
I use
name?
It? Borak.
Borak, please write that down. I'm not going to keep
did.
Track of that. Good, all roll right, it.
All right.
Ooh, yeah. Success!
Amazing.
You only need 4 more successes and 2 more failures.
I believe in us.
We can
Palila,
do this.
You're up.
So I'm on horse.
You cannot use stealth, and you cannot use animal handling. Palila. Oh, so Jack is now on a killer horse.
Yeah.
It's got like a fiery mane that doesn't really burn you. It just looks like that.
What's up?
It looks like a Rapidash from Pokemon.
Unfortunately, the horse is actually a wimp, and if it gets hurt, it's just gonna...
Yeah, exactly.
Or like Starlight...
But it still shimmer. Looks badass.
Yeah, what are you doing, Palila?
Again, in this situation, I don't know what to do. Should I just, like, not do anything?
You
no,
can
no,
skip.
You have to do something. What are your skills? What are you good at?
She is so slow.
What are you trained in?
Dex. And yeah, wisdom are high.
Dex okay. and wisdom. So you could use... Oh.
Maybe, like, use wisdom to...
I survived the door.
I survived...
Insight, maybe?
Maybe, like, you could use survival to, like, grab a tree branch and camouflage the party.
I don't think...
Yeah! I need a nat 20 for that.
Perception. Maybe you could, like, fly above us and be all like, hey, look out for
skill,
that thing.
Perceive what skill to use on the next turn.
Like, scout out the area for, like, other monsters that are around.
Yeah, tell us which direction to go and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll use perception to tell you guys how to get away from this thing without running into any more, because I can fly.
Awesome.
Okay, so
20
plus 5.
Please work.
I got a 17 plus 5.
Amazing.
Damn, so you notice perfectly just where to go and when to go. It's working phenomenal, but you do notice there's a bunch of others just patrolling about and the way you're heading.
It's like Ice Shield 21.
Quip, like, you're up.
Just looks
I
at the
am
crowd.
You cannot use arrow. Perception?
I cannot use perception. Hmm.
What was the other
so, you know, these things are magical, and casting a spell would be an arcana check.
Okay.
And it would not generally take up a spell slot, it's just flavor.
What did he use last?
Perception.
Yeah. Well, you can't use perception or perception.
Can I use...
Good luck.
I would like to use... Deception.
Ooh, how so?
Disgrace.
Deceive Tyr into going in the opposite way to distract it.
Yeah.
No, don't do that. No. We want her to live.
Then there'll just be one fail for me and one fail for the monster, and then I get eaten.
I'm gonna make it look like I'm gonna go one way, but fake out and go another way.
Yeah, good.
Do it.
Hey, whatever serpentine, works, man.
Serpentine.
Serpentine.
That's a fail.
Oh my god.
He doesn't fall for it. He just keeps charging. You have one more left before you have to fight this thing.
We need three more wins, people. We can do it.
Here, you're up.
The other and smacks into a gravestone.
All right, here. You can't use deception. You can't use athletics, I think.
Mm-hmm. So what skill does she have left, actually?
I'm going to use insight to see through his bluff and grab him before he runs into a gravestone.
Okay.
Wait, what?
I see what you're doing. Roll it.
Yeah.
Fail!
No!
All right, then.
Like, I try to grab him, and he goes the other direction.
Mm-hmm. So, how this fight will work is the fog has a weird property to it.
Oh, good.
Something happens when you're inside the fog.
Okay.
The graves will provide half cover. But the beast can break them if he just breaks them as an attack.
Okay.
There's also he's actually a huge category size. There's also the catacombs, which can be used to hide behind and get in. The beast can't get in easily.
Okay. Oh.
So use the environment.
Okay.
Am I still invisible, or am I done?
So I'm.
No, you're done.
You're done. So for this fight. Let me just expand the area you guys can start in. Let's say you guys can start anywhere in this box, and he'll start on the opposite side of the area.
Okay. All right.
And we'll use the save initiative to save time.
Okay. All right. So wait, how does cover work exactly? Can you fire spells behind the cover, or what?
Yeah, you can. You can. It just adds 2 to your AC.
Oh, okay.
Actually, let's say 3/4, it adds 5. And the buildings themselves provide full cover, and you can even go inside them.
Okay.
And you notice one of the buildings has a stairway in it, when you get in, that is.
Okay. So do you want to try and run away down the stairway or fight this thing?
Fine.
What'd you say?
Can we all reach the stairway in time?
And
probably.
If we all started over here, we could.
Over where? Okay.
But you don't know where it goes. It's a wild card.
True. There might be a beholder down there.
His name might be Doug.
His name might be Doug because he dug his way down.
And if you're asking yourself why I picked elementals and why it's named puberty, blame Wings.
Puberty?
She made a joke about fighting puberty earlier.
We can't see his name.
No.
I didn't see the
names earlier either.
Why didn't you tell me?
I thought you knew.
I just thought you didn't put them in, honestly.
Just leave it. Fine for now.
It's fine. So, there we go. Now then.
We were fighting something big today, and I asked if it was puberty.
Are we ready to go?
I'm fighting puberty.
Okay.
Okay, let's begin. So, it is going to start with Jack's turn.
All right.
So, the bonus action, I'm going to talk to the people next to me and ask them if we want to run or fight.
I don't know. You tell me.
Run. You're not next
to me. Probably run.
Yes, he is. He's right next to you.
Also, you notice about the building, it looks like it's really old and could be fairly easily knocked down by something of this thing's size.
I really think that we should go down the hole.
We don't have a lot of time. We've got like 6 seconds. That's what a turn is.
Right.
So
we gotta go down the hole.
So I guess I'm probably just gonna go from the majority and run.
I mean, we were all running to begin with, so.
Yeah, probably. Good idea.
Also, just for information, you guys know this thing is a siege monster and it does double damage to objects.
Right.
And it has tremor sense, so even if you're underground, it can still see you.
Right.
Oh, well then, in that case, if I know that, I'm probably just going to fight it, because it's going to follow us anyway.
Well, it might not be able to follow you underground is the idea.
But it'll know where we are, and it can, like...
Right.
It may not necessarily want to fight us underground. It might not want to bother.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I mean, if there's a chance we don't have to fight it, that's probably...
Is this a building, too?
Yep.
But it might drop some sweet loot.
Well, I'll give you this now. You guys have the means to kill this thing. It's a possibility. It will be hard as nails. You might lose somebody if you do it wrong. But this thing will be a huge amount of XP.
Okay, I think we should do it then.
All right, so I'm back to you. Alright, so in that case, Jack is going to cast Guiding Bolt on the thing.
Cool.
Good, you know. That's always useful.
Give it a grand old zap. Hey, natural.
Yeah, look at that. It does 20 damage.
Bang, baby.
Plus I have advantage on attack rolls against it. What?
Man, that's a really good hit.
Suck it. Sweet.
Everybody gets advantage on those attack rolls, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's shiny.
Okay, I
got it. So just the next one.
All right. So, can I cast like? Since this right here is inside a building, like I won't be able to see the monster, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I have to reopen this.
All right, then I'll stay where I am, and I'll.
You could peek around the corner, but that would be three corners cover.
Right.
Like, you can peek around cover and fire, dude. That's fine. That's allowed.
All right, then I'm going to go here, and I'm going to do the spiritual weapon, because I really like spiritual weapon.
I'm just casting that all over the
place. I'm just going to cast it right, probably like right here.
It is familiar.
Yes.
Familiar is a
problem. And then
no one's sharing their screen.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, yeah, shoot.
I'm sorry. It's my job. I'm also streaming. Mm-hmm. Everything's my job when it comes to freaking... Gosh darn it. I'm doing it.
This is the first roll of the round, so it doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. So attack with Guiding Bolt. So now, let's see if this will attack.
This has advantage, and this will use
automatically. And I get another roll. Automatically.
So up all the crits, bro.
So what is that?
So that gets rid of the advantage, by the way.
You realize I'm gonna have to.
Yeah, because.
No, it says vantage until the end of next turn.
Oh wow!
Until the end of my next turn.
Oh, never mind. Yeah. So that'll be another. How much? So that'll be 2d8 plus 5. Actually, really? Plus 3.
So it does an extra d8.
Yeah, you double the dice rolled.
Bam, it does 18 damage. Suck it.
Jesus.
Suck it.
We're going to take this thing down.
Wowza, he's still standing up pretty fine, but you've taken a chunk.
Not I did 39 damage to him.
Nicely done. Palila, you're up.
We're 38, something.
I'm still trying to bring up the spell book, so I'm just going to use the longbow attack for now.
Mm-hmm.
This guy can do a lot of damage, huh?
Yeah.
It was a 14 hit.
No.
Oh.
That's a mess. Okay. Would you want to move? Now, you can probably tell by its size and what it's made of. Spreading out's probably smart.
Yeah.
All right, I'll move it over here.
Go as far away as possible.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I have, like, crazy range, so...
So it is Quip's turn.
It is. Now, I'm going to use my favorite spell, Magic Missiles.
Which version?
Spell 2 slot, level 2 spell.
So, 44 plus 4.
What?
44 plus 4.
Oh, I was like, why? 40? It sounded like you were saying 44 plus 4.
4.
D4. I think it's anything special. And it deals 14 damage.
Good hit. Okay, is that... Do you want to move?
Yes, I would like to move.
Mm-hmm. Now, the outside of the building also provides cover.
So if I move here, what would it be?
Like, right here would be cover.
Where?
Right here.
Oh. Yeah, I'll move here then.
Tyr, you're up.
Alright, I'm gonna throw a chromatic orb at this Mosakura.
That's poison damage, right?
I can pick whatever damage I want to do.
Oh, what damage is that?
Let me check. I'm gonna do lightning damage this time. Kazap.
Also, remember, you can do Arcana or Nature checks to see its weaknesses and info from it.
Okay, I'll do an Arcana check.
That's a bonus action, let's say.
Sure.
So, first do the orb thing.
Alright. I'm gonna check. 1d20, 2 plus 2. 22.
Hit.
Yay. Alright, and then I do 3d8 damage.
Could you mute yourself there?
8 damage.
Okay, but I don't think it's me.
No, it's you, dude.
You.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. He is bloodied.
Yay. Yeah. Alright. Action surge.
Ooh. What did you say? Again?
Yeah, baby. Oh, actually, first I'm gonna do that check.
Okay. Roll Arcana.
I'm gonna see how that lightning bolt treated him. Arcana. 9.
Eh, it hit.
Yeah.
You have a feeling that non-magical weapons will be weak to him. Well, I mean, non-magical weapons will have a hard time.
Alright. I gotta say, this guy is immune to everything but cheating. 17.
Another one? Okay, that will hit.
Yay, alright.
Yeah, another chromatic orb, it's just 2.
Just
3d8, what type of damage?
A zap. Oh, 3d8 lightning damage.
Gotcha.
11.
Okay.
Alright, and now I shall...
Run?
Yeah, a little bit. Lila didn't move anywhere.
Yeah, she did.
Oh, they're in the fog, so does that do anything?
Yeah,
oh, you'll see. You get the feeling that it's invigorating.
Oh.
Oh.
Good fog?
It heals.
Interesting.
Okay, I don't need healing right now. So
a little bit.
Actually, I'm going to stay in the fog. I'm going to...
Good for melee characters, I guess.
How far? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to move over... Push me out. Under the tree. And stay in the fog.
Okay. So, he is going to just look at Palila, the only one who's still in the open. And he's just, with the fog, you notice, is beginning to put the stone that was damaged, that you knocked off him back together. And he's going to be able to spend 2 hit dice.
Gosh dang it.
Oh, what?
It's not invigorating for us, it's invigorating for the dork.
It's invigorating. Wow! He's going to heal 12 HP.
Oh my gosh.
You guys also will be invigorated by this, by the way.
Okay, good. The double crit, Brosif.
And he's just going to charge right at Palila.
Oh, no, Palila!
And he has reach. Oh, yeah, good. That's night. Neat. Nice.
Night.
So, Palila, this is gonna hurt.
Palila.
So, first, this will be plus 8. Wow! Wait, is my macro wrong? That can't...
It might be. Try it a couple more times. Try it a couple more times, please.
Oh, no, it works.
Wow.
You just suck.
The first hits a 1, but then he makes 2 hits. So this will be plus 8. Palila, will a 21 hit your AC?
Catch it.
Catch
it with your teeth.
Fly away.
Will 21 hit your AC?
Yes,
probably,
Take 2d8. What? So that will be 13 damage if you are knocked prone.
Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. Puberty is hitting her hard.
Then he is going to disintegrate into stone, and you notice him rummaging underground.
Oh no.
Oh, what?
Oh, man.
Don't do this.
It is now Jack's turn.
Gosh dang, an entire turn!
Wow. Well, what can I do?
You can check what's underground.
How would I do that? Like
perception.
Perception, how's my...
Oh, I wonder if he's down there.
I'll do a perception check to see if I can figure out where he is. Let's see. Perception.
So the ground just like cracks open and you just like...
You feel vibrations coming from this area.
I didn't see where you... That area?
Just somewhere around this vicinity.
Is there any possible way to attack him while he's underground?
Got something that shakes the ground, maybe.
Use earthquake! Use dig! We have to use earthquake!
Well, I have, let's see, I have shatter, which is a 10-foot sphere, so would that get underground?
Read the spell to me.
I don't have the exact... Gosh darn it. Okay.
Are you the originating point?
It goes shatter. A sudden loud ringing noise erupts with from a point, a 10-foot radius sphere centered on that point.
That's a ringing noise that does the damage, not so it wouldn't really go for the ground. And you don't think he had ears is another issue.
Surely sonar works.
Well, it says thunder damage, so I don't know.
Oh, well, yeah, that would probably work, but when it's above ground.
All right.
Because you can't
also,
see
beneath sweet. It also has creatures that are made of stone have disadvantage against it.
Hey!
Yeah, this also I'm going to be honest, has a vulnerability to thunder.
Oh, wait, our attacks were supposed to have advantage.
Yes, they were, but they all hit anyways.
Yeah, so... But when a creature is weak against something, does that mean that it deals, like, more damage?
Double damage.
Oh, okay, I have something that's just going to... All right. I kind of need to see if I can lure it out, so...
A person could do that, you know?
A person...
A person named Jack Daniels?
I don't know, so... But if I'll I try and, like, lure it out, I'm going to get attacked, like...
Would your sword... sword lure it out?
It's flying. I would say it wouldn't. It's not like it can be attacked. Points for creativity, though.
That's what I was thinking, but I was like, nah, it's not.
Would a dragonling lure it out?
Yeah.
Don't sacrifice your dragonling. No.
Sacrifice it.
Am I that despicable?
Yes.
Yes.
No. Okay, you want to, on your turn, you can order it to fly, you know.
That's true.
Well, Jack Daniels won't be able to do pretty much anything this turn.
Well, you told us that it's over here. You can ready an action.
What do you mean, ready an action?
You can say, when he comes out of the ground, I do this.
Well, that's... You have to remember, he has a burrow speed. So he could move, and then the ready action will be useless. So you got to try and balance it out and word your action smartly.
Yeah. So, like, use a ranged attack and say, when he comes out of the ground, I will attack him with a ranged attack. And yeah. I think that if you hold an action, then it means that you change your initiative order, doesn't it?
Yeah, I would just prefer the ready idea, where you say, when this happens, I get to do this. Okay. It's a nice risk versus reward. I don't like the just my niche. I take my turn then.
Alright, so for the action, do I have to specifically list everything that I do, or just...
You list a thing you do, you list the effect, and you list the cause.
Yeah.
Wait.
Generally, it's one action, such as, when he comes out, I swing my sword.
Okay, well then, I'm going to stay where I am, and when he comes out, I'm going to use Shatter on him with Channel Divinity. To deal the max damage, which with his disadvantage to that type of damage will be like 48 damage against him.
Yeah, that would hurt.
So,
Palila's turn.
Okay.
How hurt are you?
So, well, if I had 30 minus 13, then still have.
Does she heal?
Oh, yeah, no. She could use a hit dice. So you can use the hit dice as an action.
Oh, you can?
Yeah.
I actually do have a spell that, like, you cast it, and you can get, like, magic berries that restore hit points.
Guaranteed. But that's out of combat. It's good berry.
Yeah, okay. So combat.
It's, you could do it, but you'd have to pick the berries as, in, like, a bonus action.
Alright. Just roll a hit die.
Okay, roll a hit die. D10 plus con. I'll just, I have a macro for a D10. So heal 6 plus con health.
Con is, I think it's 2.
Okay. So it is now Quip's turn.
Hmm.
You feel the rumbling getting closer, Quip.
To me?
Yeah. Rumble, rumble.
Okay, get away, Quip, because my thing has an area of effect, so... Yeah.
Hey, that sounds like vengeance.
I don't know what to do.
And if you are in that area of effect, you will die. Like, just straight up.
Are
like,
you kidding me? What do you mean?
I don't think so.
He will die.
Because he wants to use the max damage ability on it, so...
Oh.
I will deal 48 damage.
Oh.
He will just straight up get killed if he's in
and
there.
And Quip has, like... how much health do you have, Quip?
That's a good amount.
Oh, regarding vengeance, I was talking about me. Okay. I used an area of effect on you earlier, so...
Doesn't Quip have, 24 health?
Yeah.
Straight up be murdered if that hit you.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'm sure that Jack wouldn't do that to me.
Well...
Okay,
I wouldn't. I wouldn't. In character, I wouldn't. So I'd probably just not use them. I probably would just...
Okay.
Would Jack see... as your bonus action, Quip, you want to, like, say...
Jack, I'm going to be... Yeah, unless Quip says something, Jack, you don't know he's there.
Yeah, so if you want to use your bonus action to tell me that it's coming for you so I can unready my action or something, then...
I'm just going to move. One, two,
what are you?
3, 4, 5.
Quip.
Yeah.
That is going to provoke.
That's a really bad
from
idea.
Right under you.
I really didn't think that would provoke.
Too late. You did it, dude. From right under you, he's going to jump out and just grab you.
That was a readied action. Can he stop that action? Like,
no. No.
He has to use that action now, doesn't he?
He does, but now the beast has 3/4 cover, I'm going to say. Actually, let's say, looking at the area, let's use the sight. So Jack would be able to see from here, right?
Right. I don't think he has line of sight.
Yeah, he does not have line of sight.
Oh,
okay.
My gosh.
I'm good luck.
Quip, you got saved.
So then does that, like, my readied action just get canceled? So,
Quip, you're going to take... attack, add 8 to them.
Yeah, so don't worry.
This will be 20, so 21 versus AC.
I have,
okay, we dodged a bullet.
I don't think I can get
that okay.
One. So 2d8 plus 5, so this will be 11, 16 damage.
16 damage.
And give me an athletics or acrobatics check that has to beat a 13.
Okay. Acrobatics?
You manage to just jump out of his palm. Let's say you get moved here.
Where? Holy moly.
And it is Tyr's turn.
No!
You have the rest of your turn, but you have lost your move action.
Oh, okay, then I'll use Magic Missile on him.
Level 2 version?
Yeah, level 2.
Roll the d4s.
D20, just in case. No, it doesn't work. Mm-hmm. 12 damage.
Wonderful.
Sarah, as a default, maybe you can have your mic muted until you're ready to talk.
Can't do that.
Okay. So it is Tyr's turn.
All right. I'm going to run over here with my sword out and just scream. And also,
I'm going to say, since the wall and the tree's there, he'll have half cover against this.
Gosh dang it.
Actually, let's say the tree got uprooted when he jumped out. Let's be realistic.
Oh, let's be realistic. I'm going to swing my sword at this guy. Just kill him so hard.
Roll it.
I'm trying. I used to have a character sheet open, but it decided not to be, because it's a jerk. Weapons. Nepotism. Bah!
No, good.
That will hit for 8 damage. Good job.
Yeah.
I did. He is very hurt.
Good.
He is going to just eye you, Tyr.
Oh, good.
Now, what's going to happen here is he's going to just do a big cleave of both his arms, trying to do a...
Oh my gosh.
The first hit is a critical hit.
You get another scar? How many scars do you have at this point?
Oh, this
man.
Will be...
So many.
12, 18 plus 5, so 23 damage.
Holy crap.
And this hit, he goes in cleave, and he just smashes a hole in the wall of the building.
Yeah. I'm bloodied.
Then there's the second hit.
Ah! No!
Ah! Did Jack see him?
Oh, he got a 1 on that hit, so it just utterly misses, but it destroys the... it just breaks one other one. Then,
kind of
the same... His hands.
Yeah, okay, so he smacks me right into the wall. Just BAM! Yeah,
and that breaks the wall.
All right,
then in the same hole he came out of, he is going to crawl in... he is going to crawl into it. He's just going to jump back in and start going underground again.
Wait, really?
Oh, everybody give me a perception check.
It's cheap.
Is this the wall that he broke?
Yep, that's nothing. That's no longer a wall. I'll draw on it.
Well, then when of Jack seen it?
The condition was when he got out of underground.
Oh, all right. Well,
you got surprised by the wall being broken. So
this is a cut on her eyebrow.
Okay. Or maybe a broken spine. So, Jack, you feel tremors from over here, right in front of the building.
Great.
And it is now Jack's turn.
Well, I can't do anything on my turn again, really? You are just doing this.
Prepare an attack.
Jack, your party members are dying out there. Healing would help.
Yeah, I know.
Cleric.
No, get your attack ready again.
But then there's the same issue where if it'll kill, like, you guys if it doesn't work. So
yeah, like Whip, you're on 8 health.
Yeah, never mind then.
He can do a huge amount of damage.
That's true. And the thing is, if he manages to, like, because the lower your health is, the more dangerous it is, because the first hit that puts you below 0, if the remaining damage is higher than your maximum hit points, then it kills you outright.
It would be, for like both of you, I'm pretty sure. It would just kill both of you, just automatically.
Yeah, that's just...
I don't want to do that, so I'm going to come over here.
There's no cover there, by the way.
Right. That's why he's coming
over
there.
I'm going to say there's shards there, and that's no longer full cover, it's half cover.
Can we call it difficult terrain?
Yeah. Yeah, let's say it's diff.
I can use Cure Wounds on Quip from here, right?
Okay, are you casting that as level 1 or level 2? You guys also have potions, remember that. That's a move
true.
Action.
Bonus action, right?
Move to get it out, bonus to drink.
Okay.
Alright, I'm going to use Cure Wounds. What's his max health? What's his max health?
24.
24?
He has 8.
I'm just going to use a... I don't know. Fine, I'll use just a level 1 cure wounds on Quip.
Okay.
Yeah.
D8 plus spellcasting modifier.
So you get 6 health.
Okay, heal 6 health, Quip. Is that is your move and your standard? Anything for a bonus, like moving your sword around?
You know what? I'll use healing word as a bonus action on Quip.
Oh wow! Aren't you generous?
Yeah, I am. I'm too good to him. So he gets 7 more health.
We give him a hard time, but we like having him around.
Yeah.
You're just saying that so I don't kill him in this fight. Okay, Belila, you're up.
Are you muted? Wolf.
Sarah.
Okay.
You're in the healing vest. On your turn, you can spend a hit die if you win.
I'm at, 23, so I don't really need it.
Well, the issue is that 7 health could save your life on the next attack.
Maybe.
This guy has the possibility of dealing 24 plus 34 damage in a turn.
Great. But I have Absorb Elements as a spell, so next time... Which I didn't have a book open last time. Mm-hmm. I can take in his energy, cast a spell on me.
Okay. So what are you going to do?
Bark, you're very loud there.
Maybe to move to cover or an area less out in the open would be wise.
Yeah, I'm going to do that. So I'm going to fly. 2, 3, 4, 5.
Your flight speed is 40, I believe.
Okay, so I'm going to fly right here.
Okay, that's not covered, but you're all together now. Great.
Uh-oh.
Oh, good.
Let's see, this thing's huge, so I'm guessing one of these could probably hit 2 of you at once.
Let's
hope it's me, honestly.
Well, I can only move 8, so I could move, I can only move, here.
Okay.
Here.
Okay, anything else you want to do?
All right.
I don't think so. No.
Okay.
Alright.
Quip, you're up.
Yes, I am.
Tyr's gonna yell at you to get to cover.
Mm.
She's still bleeding on the ground. You know how, head wounds bleed, excessively? Mm.
If I move...
Doing the anime thing where it's running down her face, but it doesn't get in her eye.
Can I move into the building since the wall's destroyed?
Yeah, it's difficult terrain, so the purple will cost you 2 movement squares.
So where would I be? Would I be able to move here?
Yeah, you'd be able to get down there.
Yeah, I'm going to go down there. There's no way we're beating this thing.
As you get down there, you notice a very open room... of just catacombs, graves that has seemingly collapsed in on itself, as you would notice a big beast walking around.
A big what?
A big, giant stone beast is in the cave.
Okay, I'm going to walk back upstairs.
I think it's the end of your move, actually.
Yeah, I'll let him do it. I'll let him do it.
Okay.
You look down there, and you just see the beast itself.
Is that our big, giant stone beast?
Nope. Wait, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Is it? I think I'd be able to tell.
Yeah, it's the same beast.
Oh.
It's got the same chunks and wounds. It's
okay.
It burrows in the ground, then just runs around under there to make it faster to move.
Oh, I'm going to tell them about it then. Hey, guys. It's down here. Come on.
Oh, sweet. That's actually super useful.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Right. Tyr, you're up.
I'm going to get up and... I'm going to hear that, and I'm going to...
No, actually, everyone should, I was going to say, everyone should stay up here, that way I can go down by myself, and you should...
Oh, so wait, before I forget, Quip, give me a stealth check.
A stealth check? Oh, god damn it, Brent.
I forgot to ask that.
I'm using second wind.
Okay.
Stealth.
So as Tyr is taking a breath, it doesn't notice you.
Yeah, totally. But
Nat 20.
Okay, so Tyr, what do you do?
There's the monster down there, yes.
Mm-hmm. But it can easily get to the surface. Like it's five feet of its move action to get to the surface.
That's true. And he would have to. What action would it be to figure out where he is?
Give me just a bonus action perception.
Wait. If Quip stays there, could he tell us where he is?
Yeah.
Oh. You know, I guess
we'll do that. Quip. You have 21 health?
What? No, I don't.
Yeah, because I healed you using the healing word afterward. But
now, you have to remember, this catacomb is kept up through stone columns that it could easily knock down.
Okay, I'm gonna yell at Quip. Where is he?
Where is he, Brent?
About here.
There?
He's about here.
Okay. Well, fighter gonna fight. Gonna get up. Dust myself off, pick up my sword, run at it.
So, move your character. You are going to provoke its ready to action.
Yep.
It's going to jump out of the ground and grab you with its hand. Will an 18 hit your AC?
Yes, gosh, it will.
So this is going to be 2d8.
Okay.
So 10 plus 15 damage. Golly. And it's going to throw you.
Oh my gosh!
Wow. Give me an athletics check. Give me a con or strength save, whichever you would prefer. Con to take the hit and take less damage, or strength to get him to stop him from throwing you.
I'm gonna do strength.
Okay. Now let's add this all together. So he gets a plus 5, plus 3, so 15. So plus 3, 8. So yeah, you pass the DC for the throw, and you are put right in front of him. You managed to wiggle his way out.
I'm gonna stab him.
Ah, sweet, he's right on top of my sword.
Okay. Roll your attack.
Alright.
Hey, we're second level spell. We can have second level spells?
Yeah. Actually, you can't. Your rangers don't
have 15 versus DC.
I only wanted to use that level 2.
That will 16 versus AC will miss.
No.
It is now its turn.
I'm gonna cry. Mm-hmm. Goodbye, my friend.
Uh oh.
It's just gonna walk sidestep and walk into the building, breaking the other wall.
Oh my gosh.
What?
One, and it's just gonna slam both fists down, one at Jack and one at here. The first one will be against Tia. 18 versus AC.
Uh-oh.
Oh, gosh.
Take 17 damage.
I'm down.
And Jack, 19.
Yeah.
Versus AC. So take 15 damage.
We're so dead.
Then for the rest of its move, it's going to go underground.
Okay.
Right on top of the pillar, collapsing it, bringing you all into the catacombs level.
Goodbye, cruel world.
Everybody except Tyr, who's unconscious, give me a con save. DC 10 to see if you can stand upright or are knocked prone by the place falling.
Okay, I have good con.
Yes.
You pass. Sarah, could you mute yourself?
I can't really hear.
Okay.
You pass. Now, yes. Sarah, give me a con save.
Oh, hello.
Sarah, please mute.
I don't think even she can hear me.
Right. My mouse, it goes over the thing and then it goes away.
Okay, just roll a d20. Your con's 10. I'll just roll a d20 for you. Here, I have a macro. You pass. So none of you are not prone? Actually, no, Quip. Yeah, none of you are not prone by the thing falling.
I am.
But now, let me
Isn't
just...
Isn't she flying anyway?
Oh, she said she got the cover.
Oh, okay.
So now let me just doodle all this. Basically, this whole building is difficult terrain now. Okay?
Okay, this thing is bloodied, yes?
Very.
Oh, gosh. Guys, we can take it. I know we can. We can kill this thing.
And it's Jack's turn.
Probably even before I die. Oh.
Yeah, I can just kill outright right now.
All right,
I'm gonna cast Shatter like right here so that it only affects the monster.
Okay.
I'm gonna use my Channel Divinity so that automatically does 24 damage. Mm-hmm. And since it's since you said it was
So it's a burst 10?
Excuse me?
Burst 10?
Yeah, it's
gotcha.
So it doesn't hit anyone except it.
Gotcha.
So it does like 48 damage to it, I believe.
You have to roll it to hit first.
I shouldn't.
How does the spell... Read the spell to me.
It says it has to do a con save to see how much damage it takes, but it doesn't, like...
Okay, this thing has insane con.
Oh, no.
So this will be... Wait, I rolled twice. It got a 14 plus 5 plus 3. So 14 plus 8,
Brent,
23.
I just said I'm doing the thing to deal max damage automatically.
Yeah, so but you still hit, but you do max damage, then it's halved.
Because
he succeeded on the save.
I think that's how...
Flipping through the book!
That is what I'm doing. I don't think that's...
Cleric. Read Shatter to me.
Read Shatter? A sudden loud ringing noise, painfully intense, erupts from a point within range. Each creature in a 10-foot radius sphere centered on that point must make a constitution saving throw. A creature takes 3d8 thunder damage on a failed save, or half as much damage on a successful one.
See, so he succeeded, so he'll take half, which would be 12, since you maxed it, times 2, so 24. So he is very hurt. Like
He also has disadvantage on the throw, so you have to roll again to see...
Ah, thank you.
So
your DC is...
Oh, dude, your second roll was a nat 1, though.
Oh, shoot. I was just going to roll again. Huh.
It was nat 1.
So
nat 1. Okay, so it hits.
And it's 48 damage?
48?
Yeah.
He is alive.
Oh!
Okay, so I deal 48... I dealt 48 damage to when it's still alive? What the hell?
Ooh, it has got us in the fog.
Hit it with everything you have, you can do it. I believe in you.
I forgot it's in the fog, guys.
How does it look?
So it's going to use a two hit dice.
Gosh dang!
I forgot about that.
Murder you.
Almost dead.
Is the fog underground?
No, like he broke the ground itself. Like he collapsed the catacomb. So you're
then
above
how
ground.
Is it still in the fog?
Fog though? Takes longer to fall than bodies do.
You're correct. Good point. He does not use it.
So he's like almost dead or something? That.
He is really almost dead.
As soon as I die, I officially take up rules.
Guess
lawyer.
What? I still have a bonus action with my spiritual weapon.
Yo! Bring so it in, baby.
I'm going to bring it over to the monster. I'm going to see if it hits.
I like the idea that we're all in a hole, and like you just... It's like, it's still not dead? And then like your sword just comes whipping in, just...
Swing. This better give us a lot of XP.
Better. Goddamn better.
I'm moving the shit out of it.
Oh my gosh.
So a 10?
Yeah, that's not going to hit, right?
No.
I don't know. I don't think I can miss something that big, personally, but, you know, whatever. It's just me.
Gosh darn.
Now I'll say the thing failed. Can I say the fog is fouled now? Is that fair?
Yes, sure.
So I'll let him spend his hit dice.
You're the stinking DM.
I thought that couldn't be until it was his turn. Well, whatever.
I would allow you guys to do the same as well. Like, let's be real here. Like, on Tyr's turn, she could probably do it. But I just forgot to do the heal earlier. So 13.
Oh, really?
Oh, fine. You know what? You can't do the heal if you're unconscious, and he won't do it either.
Oh.
Quip, you're up.
Magic missile.
What about me?
Yeah,
no, it's Palila.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about you? Sorry.
All right. should have used the spell this time. Alright, I'm gonna attack with my longbow, and then if it hits, I'm gonna use Hunter's Mark as a bonus action to deal an extra.
You should do the Hunter's Mark first. So okay, your longbow gets the bonus.
First. And I cast that. Alright, so I'm just gonna cast Hunter's Mark, and then.
Miss.
No. It's doing really bad today.
Would you like to move or do anything else?
You'll provoke if you move, so I probably wouldn't.
So I won't move.
Quip, you're up.
Can I take a look at how well he's doing?
He looks weak.
Like, very, very weak?
He looks weak.
How weak, Brent? There's different levels of weak.
He looks weak. He's a massive stone. You can't really tell how weak it is.
Well,
because he looked worse earlier, but then he put himself back together.
Or is he like, cracked? Or is he...
He's always just cracked. He's made out of pure earth.
You're just being difficult on purpose now.
Yeah. Hey, dude, let's be real here. How would you tell if a thing that's made of slabs of stone looked weak?
Like, I'm if there's, like, big gashes in it?
Well, there's already were, and you guys have done a lot to him. I mean, let's be real here. He's weak. That's okay. As much I'm giving you. You want to just see his HP?
Yeah.
Give me a perception check.
Really?
See his HP. Yeah, give me a perception check.
Two. Oh. Never
it
mind.
It don't matter. You jerks.
Seven, nothing happened. I'm using the magic missile level 1.
Roll damage.
And I got 12.
He is at -11 health. He falls to pieces.
Yes. I killed it.
And wow. Buries Tyr's body.
And then you notice there's a stone, a large slab of stone on Tyr's leg.
Oh, gosh. Oh,
heal her.
Well,
what can I do?
Yeah, use your magical powers.
You can stop sharing the screen now, Talon.
Oh, is Arcus doing that thing that, like, sad dogs do when their owners are hurt?
No.
Oh, okay.
He's just sort of on top of you, sitting on your face right now.
Did he find something shiny?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
So I'm going to run over.
Notice that there's... You notice something shiny in the rubble of the beast.
Ooh, I want to get it.
Ooh, okay. Arcus wants it.
No, I'm getting it. I'm
Arcus
already
wants
there.
It.
I'm there.
I'm lifting the slab off of Tyr's leg.
Yeah, I'm at the... So I'm there first.
It's a... Okay, Arcus and Quip, give me an athletics check.
You're kidding me.
Oh my gosh, I'm so glad to finally have Arcus here.
It's a I'm just getting hit out of the way.
Whoa, roll an attack against Arcus.
21!
Oh my god.
Arcus just runs into the pile and picks up with his mouth. It looks to be a ruby skull.
Oh, wait. I need...
It goes into the handy haversack.
It'll go along great with my red crystal.
The first part of his hoard is now complete.
Yep, Arcus puts it in the handy haversack.
Yeah! Oh.
So, animal hand. So, you managed to get Tyr out of there, and you're up at 1 HP.
Can I trade with you, Wings?
Who, me?
Yeah, for the
rest. It's not hers, it's the dragon's.
Oh,
can I trade with the dragon? I don't know about it, I was unconscious the whole time.
Can I trade with the dragon?
What? No, it's my dragon.
I'm going to put the beggar's tooth in front of him, try and distract him, then go for the skull.
It's in the handy haversack now.
I'm going to open up the sack. I'm just going to reach in there, grab up the skull.
Now, I'm going to say each of you get 500 XP.
It's on Tyr's body.
No, that's it. Only 500.
That's a lot.
Not really.
All right. Well,
guys, that's a huge amount.
Yeah, sure, Brent.
Thinking about it like this, it would take you 3 games to get to level 4. With what you guys just did, you are on track to be level 4 by next game. So 2.
How much XP are we at right now?
2,100.
2,100?
Yep. Yeah. You need 600 more.
Oh, I thought that we were at a low.
You guys got a huge amount today. And I got to factor... Actually, I have to factor in the skill encounter. So that's about an average fight. So an average fight for... let me pull up the stats for it. So an average fight for level 3 is 150 XP, right? I mean, 150 XP each, right?
Yeah.
So let me just pull up the exacts.
So basically what happened is that Arcus ran up and grabbed that skull and then went into Tyr's handy haversack, which is on her person. So when she wakes up, Quip is trying to dig through her bag. Yeah. So she's just going to punch him, just straight up deck him.
Okay, you roll an attack for me. For the skill check, you'll each get 150 XP.
This is amazing.
Oh, so we got another 150?
Mm-hmm. So now,
2250 then.
Somebody who, if you can get it away from Arcus, that is, somebody give me a check on that skull.
Okay, can I check it?
If you can get it away from the dog.
Okay, I'm going to grab from the dog.
Palila, as he's chasing down the dragon trying to get the skull, you notice that in the class catacombs, he collapsed a tomb with a lot of... The dragon didn't notice it, but there's just a lot of seemingly treasure. Probably a rich person.
Oh, we can get all the treasure.
Quip, you don't know this. You're chasing the dragon.
Oh, I still want the ruby skull. So I'm going to keep chasing the dragon.
I'm going to check out this ruby skull. I rolled an 11.
Okay, so give me a handle animal check.
Oh, who,
can
me?
Can Jack roll a handle animal check too?
I want to handle the animal.
17.
And I got a 15.
Okay, so Tyr does it first. You handle animal and you find the skull. Mm-hmm. This was once human. There's something off about it. It was turned into this and used to power those things.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to listen to it.
You're going to put your ear up to it?
Yeah.
As you put your ear up to it, you hear, like, it sounds muffled, but it's basically like if you took somebody's blood-curling, dying scream and lowered down the volume. You're hearing the person's last noise it made.
Kill your friends.
Just, you're hearing the blood-curdling scream as it looks to have been crystallized.
Is it cursed?
Huh.
You don't know, but it's probably fetch a lot in the market. Now, let's go to Palila. You've just noticed a vault of treasure this thing opened.
I would like to check that out.
Okay, you walk in there and... There's just there's a lot in there. There looks to be about 500 gold. Just throughout bags. There's a set of plate mail. The person in this catacomb looked to be an elf, and there's a set of plate mail. Apparently they wore.
Can I take all this stuff?
Let me explain all. You find a weird sort of scroll. Give me a... What languages do you speak?
I speak...
Comprehend languages?
You identify this as a scroll of locate person. This scroll, one time, can be used to find anybody. You speak their name as you use the scroll, and it will tell you where they are.
Oh, we can use...
Make a map of the location of where they are.
Oh. Who's that?
Can Arcus start taking gold?
Mm-hmm. What?
Baboo, no!
You also see something really peculiar.
What?
Palila, you see a cabbage in a cage. Just like a little bird cage has a cabbage in it.
What?
I probably shouldn't touch it.
Can I go
touch it? From its direction, you hear the word fucking mixed blood.
It's a talking cabbage!
I don't think I should go near that. It doesn't like me.
I'm too good for you. You fucking mixed blood.
Apparently, you think you're too good for me.
Isn't it obvious?
You're a cabbage.
Look here, feathery lady. You obviously ain't natural. Go ahead back to your test tube.
And the talking cabbage
well,
is natural.
If you're a talking cabbage, you obviously aren't natural either.
You hear Palila talking to somebody from in the catacombs.
Palila, who are you talking to?
As you walk down, you see a suit of plate mail tier that looks like it could fit you.
Ooh, I take it.
Can you put it on?
I'm going to look at it first.
It's a normal suit of plate mail.
Oh, I'm going to use an Arcana check on it. Nah, 18.
It's a normal suit of plate mail.
I put it on.
You have now, your AC is now 18.
Yeah.
Oh, you're
no.
The new tank.
And
the, yay!
And
I
then
always was
the tank. As you walk down, you hear the cabbage says it to you. Oh, well, if it isn't a Miss High and Mighty Elf. Took you time to come down here. Get to your own cut, fucking country, you immigrant.
Oh my gosh.
This point, Jack's going to come on. What's going on?
This cabbage has dishonored me. I think I'm supposed to kill it now.
Let's fight the
right?
cabbage.
Am I supposed to kill this cabbage? Jack, what do you think?
Kill the cabbage.
I think we should kill it and eat it.
Okay,
I
let's stab the cabbage.
That we need to save the cabbage.
Let's eat the cabbage.
Stab the cabbage.
Now you have the cabbage on your sword. It's like, I'm a cabbage. Not something, it's not some fleshy like you guys.
Take a bite out of it, Jack.
No.
The goat.
Just stop bleeding the cabbage.
Feed it to the dragon.
Quip, eat this.
No. Get that away from me.
Whoa,
pointing
there.
Pointing at the end of my sword.
Whoa, wow. Thank you, your lord. Took the time out to leave the nine hells just to see me. Fucking demon bastard.
Yeah. Wow, he's
you're welcome.
Racist to everybody.
He didn't say anything about me.
Animated fruit or vegetable.
I'm gonna point him at Jack and see if he's racist towards humans, too.
The cabbage just cabbages and says, fucking white purse people. Fucking
excuse
whitey.
Me?
Fireball! You heard me, cracker.
Oh my god.
I'm just gonna lunge and take a bite out of it.
I let him.
Okay, give me a con save.
Amazing.
Ooh, Jack?
Yeah?
Alright.
Oh my gosh, this is bad. Take a bite out of crime.
I have +3 to con. Why are all my con saves sucking today?
You're gonna take 2d6 poison damage.
Oh my gosh.
Take 11 damage. You just, as you bite in, this acid comes out of it. Apparently, its personality is as toxic as it is.
Oh, gross. It's a poisonous cabbage. Who wants the poisonous cabbage?
That's what you get for taking a bite out of me, you fucking cracker.
Okay, take your sword, put it on the ground, hold it down, take your sword, stab it repeatedly, and then cut it into different pieces.
Whoa, if you let me live, I'll give you some info.
I don't care. You're ugly and stupid, and you've done nothing but insult us since we met you. My
you
honor
dictates. You poisoned me!
Also that.
No, dude, I'm not poisonous. I'm toxic.
Quip, talk to this cabbage.
Okay.
Before I murder it.
Yeah, there. So your name's Quip, demon boy.
Yeah.
What can I get you, you commie bastard?
I'm a communist.
You're your red rag one.
I'm gonna cast Firebolt at it.
Whoa, buddy.
I told
buddy,
you can, to talk to him.
Let's just talk here.
Okay.
Come on, I can help you.
Why are you here?
I was the. He looks at he. He just. He doesn't really do anything, he's just the owner of this catacomb, the body. I was his pet back in the day.
Amazing.
I've been kind of lonely.
Amazing.
You
want to
be my pet?
Oh my gosh.
I'm
going to get Firebolt ready.
I'm guessing. Whoa. A talking cabbage, quite the odyssey. I'm sure a zoo would like me, they might pay you a bit.
You don't want to be my pet? I say as my firebolt gets bigger and bigger.
Sure.
Yay!
I'm quite old, a couple hundred
You'll
years.
You'll live. Is it a life worth living?
Yeah. I've been with this elf for a long time. Check his body. You're the elf in the coffin.
Oh, he's an elf.
I want to open up the coffin.
I'm going to kick open the coffin with my
No, blade. I'm opening up the coffin. There.
Do, like, the dramatic, like,
The guy was a alchemist, and you open up the coffin and see his bones are made out of mithril.
What?
Yeah, bastard did that to himself.
Is the ruby skull his?
No.
Oh. I'm going to take his bones.
Marcus will bite off a finger off his...
What's you have a feeling that if you could get somebody to smelt this, you could make a nice piece of armor out of this.
Amazing.
Yeah, so
I can use armor because my AC is only 15.
Yeah.
You can.
Well, if you wear a armor, dude,
hey,
you can't fly.
Hey, can you wear chainmail?
No, she if she wears anything higher than like padded, she can't fly.
Can anybody wear chainmail?
Sure.
Anybody want chainmail?
Well, I'm already wearing chainmail, so.
Okay.
Right. Can I have the bones? Like, can I put them in my handy haversack for later?
Yeah, if you put them in the next town, somebody could definitely smelt these for you.
I've got a finger.
Excuse me?
See? Isn't that useful? Now, I know a lot. I was taken out of here by some weirdos who were digging up bodies a while back, and they put me back in here. Yeah. They didn't like me, apparently.
Yeah,
I guess I'm not
surprised.
Nice.
So Jack is going to say, thank you for the mithril. He's going to pull out his sword.
No, I'm
Wait,
protecting the cabbage.
Brent.
Yeah.
He's still
Brent,
gonna sword
is, this,
the
is this cabbage based off of you?
No.
What?
That's the NPC that I identify as the evil cabbage.
I had to ask.
Look, how about this? Okay. You help me, I help you.
I don't
I kind of want you as a pet.
Can we kill him?
Look. I am trapped in the cabbage.
I don't mind having a cabbage pet.
So what were you before you were a cabbage?
Pit Lord.
A what?
Pit Lord.
Excuse me?
Heck is a Pit Lord.
Demon?
Oh.
Oh.
Okay, I'm gonna
also
put the
cabbage
in my cabbage.
So, blah blah blah, alchemist, my old buddy, we've been traveling for years before the guy kicked a bucket of the asshole. So, when he first found me, you know, I made my way through my life, and he just starts telling his life story about how he woke up one day in the Nine Hells as a lemur, and just over centuries and centuries worked his way up, becoming higher level demon, till he eventually was one of the guardians of the Nine Hells as a pit lord.
Huh.
Then one day he tripped and fell into a circle that somebody drew, and woke up inside of a crystal in an alchemist shop, which was then infused into a cabbage.
Amazing.
Hmm.
So yeah, that's how I've got here. Now this was a long story.
I'm gonna about halfway through that story, like Tyr's gonna open up Quip's handy haversack and just kind of like put it over the cabbage and.
Nope. This is my cabbage.
So if
it's your handy haversack, I'm putting it in your bag.
No, you. Oh, you're okay.
So in this game, he has a pet cabbage, and the other game, he has a cat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So can I put the cabbage in my
hand?
The cat doesn't talk
about it. Whoa! If you can free me, I will make you immensely powerful.
Will you make me a full-fledged demon?
A freaking pit lord?
Oh. Hey, pit lord, do you know anything about this scar on my shoulder? Because it's all demonic-like.
Oh, you're related to the Leviathan.
Oh. What does that mean exactly?
That is a giant.
It's this giant godly sea turtle.
Oh,
you must be a kin of it or something.
A kin? I'm human. No sea turtle here. I got no.
Well, buddy, I know my giant god beasts. I kind of was one of them.
There's no shame in that, Jack. I mean, we can't choose who our family is.
I'm just
Have you noticed fish talking to you?
No.
The urge to swim around, the urge to duck into a shell. I don't know what the turtles do.
I think you're just being offensive at this point.
He can actually do that.
Wait, I have an important question here.
What is it, bud?
No, this is for you, Brent. Is the cabbage in my pack like a little chihuahua?
Yes, you can have it in your bag.
Like one of those ladies from the TV show.
Amazing.
So here's the deal. As much as I like working for wizards, they're a blast to be around. Their descent into madness as they get older and have less and less control of their magic is just phenomenal to watch. It's a truly spectacular thing. If you're ever Cabbage, I recommend it. This one here nearly destroyed the world.
I would recommend it.
As much as I like this, I would prefer to be in my normal state as a Pit Lord. I loved my job. I really did. It was fun.
Okay.
So if you can release me, let's see, what can I go? I can't offer you immortality. That's not allowed. I got in trouble for that last time.
Why can I have immortality?
I got yelled at by Asmodeus last night. Okay, let's see. I can't give you, make you a blank. I just lost that artifact. Nothing. I could give you a cool sword. That's pretty.
Oh,
no.
What kind of sword exactly?
Ooh.
I killed off this Arthur. Just this Arthur kid came to me a couple hundred years back. I killed that thing. Let's see. I can't grant you a wish. I'm not a genie.
No. Really sword. Go back to the sword, please.
Wait, I want the artifact.
No, Jack, we can't. It's not honorable. Oh.
Then there's that shield. Oh, I got a good one. How about infinite wealth?
No.
No, thank you.
Boring.
Yeah, that's actually really boring.
And sword, shield, hello?
I've already got high up.
Oh, the sword? Yeah, just this Arthur boy came to me a couple of
years ago. Is it a great sword?
Yeah, it looked like a toothpick to me, but I was huge back then.
Where is the sword?
Yeah. Do we really want
to? How do we know that we actually have the sword?
It's in my own vault.
What?
I'm a pit lord at a house and everything. It just kept it there with my other treasures.
Okay, pit lord. How do we know that as soon as we free you, you won't kill us?
Exactly.
I mean, you are a demon.
I'm a devil. Devils are we're lawful. We serve Asmodeus. If I break my word, I'll be demoted. I don't want to be a Lamia again. Those things suck. There's so many arms.
Let's table this for now. There's a Tarrasque on the loose.
Oh, the Tarrasque up again?
Yeah.
Bastard beat me in cards last time. Just kidding. They don't play. They don't play cards. Those guys are weird.
Okay, but like this guy jokes about playing cards with a Tarrasque. Do we want to let him?
I got an idea.
Yeah.
What?
I mean, I'm not really as strong as the Tarrasque, but having me on your side could put a huge dent in it.
Okay, then. If we free you, will you help us fight and also give us a sword?
I swear on my master, Asmodeus.
Wait.
Here's an important question. How do we intend to do this?
Yeah.
You guys are fucking wizards.
He's right.
How do we free you?
I was trapped in here. I'm sure somebody could take out a demon out of it. Maybe if you guys know a wizard or if you guys are it, could have something.
I'm a sorcerer. Would that work?
Yeah, let's hope.
Okay, I'm going to try and put the demon in my body.
He didn't tell anybody that, so he's just doing it.
Give me an arcana check.
Oh, God. He's just going to be...
Please be low.
What is Arcana again?
Please be low.
Plus intelligence. 5. Intelligence plus 2, I believe, for you.
Okay. No.
19.
Amazing.
So you go to bring it up to you.
Yeah.
Actually, it would be 21. So you go to bring it up to 21. You think you just sense that there's something inside it connecting it to this. You may be able to connect it to yourself, but that much power would kill you. It may be able to take over your body, and then it would have a human form. It wouldn't necessarily be a pit lord. It would just be taking over Quip's body.
Well, can I do that?
Try it.
No.
It'll totally work.
Brent, out of character, if I were to do that, could I play as the Pit Lord?
You would play. You could play as the racist cabbage.
Oh, I want to play as a racist.
But I think at that point you would become an NPC.
Yeah.
Oh, come on! I want to play as the Pit Lord in my body.
That's a little.
You could give me a wicked con save. You know what? If you want to attempt it.
Okay.
Give me a con save.
That's like a nat 20, man.
So my con
like
is
a nat 20.
Wait. The idea is either super low or super high would probably function if I'm thinking right. I'm gonna start writing down my ideas. Give me a con save and I'll see how it plays into what I'm writing.
Okay. Wait 1 second. I need to refresh my roll 20.
Yeah. That's all right.
Because, you know...
Whoa, buddy. What are... Are you going to put me inside you?
No.
Wait.
No.
Wait. No. What are you trying to do, Cliff?
No, don't... This guy don't know nothing.
Then you would have to barter conjuring the cabin. Might be you could have freed me then.
Huh. Yeah, everything's going really slow.
Amazing.
Do you want me to roll for you?
Nope, got it.
No!
What I get, what'd what
you I get? You got a nat 20.
Oh my gosh.
So you go and put it inside yourself, and you just start glowing this radiant light as the gem bursts out of the cabbage and goes into you. You now have just right at the base, like the, I'm going to say right in like the mid, the cleavage region, you just have this red gem in you.
Oh.
You hear it coming from, you hear it inside your head. Did that work?
Oh, it's all like Naruto now. Nine Fox.
My gosh.
Whoa. Can you let me talk to the group here for a second? I'm confused.
Okay, I'm going to give him control of my body because, you know.
Oh my gosh.
He's just what? Quips his hands go to his head. Hello, every.
All right, I'm gonna.
Is that what I was? I was in a cabbage the whole time.
I'm gonna draw my sword. Yeah.
Wait, no. I have the You may let the Pit Lord out, and he could get back to his body. And then you have a Pit Lord who won't help you because he's in the Pit Lord's body. But if he's in me, I can control him, and I can become like Naruto, and I can kill everyone.
Is this Quip talking, or is this...
No,
the demon's gonna interrupt. Okay, your name's Quip. Nice to meet you. If you can get me to my own body, I will fight the Tarrasque with you, or whoever you have, and give you a weapon if you guys want. I don't care. This is everyday business for me.
I'm gonna look at Jack and be like, honorable death?
No, wait. Just because he's in my body now doesn't mean that we can't get him into his body again.
Wait. Quip, are you still there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
I'm here too.
Holy crap, how did you... This isn't right.
Sword
is pointed at him.
Wait, would... I feel like the
Hey, wait, chick.
Because he would kill me.
Wait, chick.
Yeah?
Can you calm down your friends and let us just talk?
What I'm talking out, guys.
There's nothing we can do about it.
Okay. What? Oh, first off, where are we still on the Grave Meadow? It's been a while. I've been out of there.
Yeah, we're above the we're in the catacombs, right?
Yeah. I haven't gone outside in a long. Is the necropolis still standing?
Maybe.
For now.
You know that's the old name of the school before it was turned into a school.
We don't actually know if it's still standing or not.
It should be. The thing's like, you guys been traveling for like a day. The beast is four days off when you left.
Okay, then I'll just say that it should be still standing unless the beast has speed up like extremely fast.
Maybe somebody there could release me.
Do we want to go back? I don't really think so.
Right now? No, we're in the middle of something.
Yeah, we can't just abandon the quest.
Okay, so what's your quest?
We're trying to stop the... What's it called?
You're trying to gain information about the devourers as you travel to the living city and get the crown there.
Yeah, that artifact that you lost.
Wait. You're trying to get the crown of the living city?
Yeah.
Not for us, but
What year is it?
2015.
I say whatever year it is.
Okay, yeah, that will I've been in there for like 3,000 years as in that.
Whoa.
So yeah, that. I don't blame you guys. That's where the crown should be, but it's not there.
What?
Wait. What?
The crown. It got moved in a war 3,000 years ago. It was back when I was working as an. I was supposed to just be digging holes and to hide stuff, and Asmodeus came riding on a horse, and he just threw the crown in there, saying nobody should ever find this.
Where is the crown?
Yeah.
It's near Driften.
Driften?
Driften.
We don't have enough time to go to Skyrim.
Driften.
Where is that exactly? I just ask, like, anyone where Driften is.
It's the land of the Dragonborn.
It's about 4 days off. It's,
You keep
it's
on
actually, walking. Think of it as, if you go, you're in Oban right now. Oh, yeah. If you just go west near, it's a coastal city.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Well, to get to Skyrim, though, you need to go
I mispronounced it. It's Driften.
But to get to Skyrim, you need to keep on going north until you see a man with an arrow in his knee.
But yeah, we buried that thing.
Yeah, let's go get the crown, then.
But wait. The living city's been opened?
Yeah.
Damn! This is a fun time period.
Too bad you're stuck in my body.
That's kind of gross.
Need a little bit
more.
What? Say, Pit Lord, what would happen if I broke that?
Call me Malfurion. Wait, no, that's a worth it. Damn it! Why are all the good demon names taken? I'm gonna go look up demon names. 1 second.
How about?
I'm going to call him Cabbage Lord.
Yeah, he's gonna end up being Cabbage Lord no matter what. So
you know what?
We can call him Cabby for short.
That's exactly what I was gonna say.
You know what?
Cabby.
Do you want to know my I probably shouldn't share my. You know the old
saying. Yeah.
The first way to fight a demon is to say its name.
Learn its name. So. Yeah.
But you guys, if you guys are gonna trust me at all, you probably should know. It's Belder.
Builder.
B-E-L-D-R.
Bob Builder?
Do you have a gate? That's what I need to know.
A what? What did you say, boy?
Oh, yeah, I forgot. He's racist.
Belder's gate. Yeah?
No, wait, not Boulder. Belder.
Yeah.
Belder.
No.
It's an Arabic gate.
I know.
It's like weak mistletoes and shit.
My gosh.
Okay, so what's the plan?
I can't believe that even worked.
I
got a nat 20. I was just
it was one of those magical moments where there was no possible way we could have, like,
5%.
Oh my gosh. The idea was a 1 would have put him in control. Anything in like a 2 through 10 would cause Quip to be hurt. 11 through 19 would have caused not work, and a 20 would have made a symbiotic relationship, was the idea.
Now I'm Naruto.
So, you guys are talking. What are you guys doing here? What's that? So first off, what was that beast that broke into my catacomb?
I have no idea.
It was a golem, right?
What are golems doing here?
Well, there's this thing with the cult.
Yeah, there's a cult.
There's a devourer. Oh, they're here?
Yeah, they put this mark on me with the Leviathan thingy.
Oh, somebody there might be able to fix me, but I guess you guys don't want to do that. That's too bad.
Great. So, Palillo's been assembled by a mad scientist. Quip is possessed by a pit lord. And...
Well, not possessed.
Jack is a
Like, in Dragon Ball Z Abridged, it's sort of like Piccolo and all the people inside him right now.
Right.
It's symbiotic.
Yeah. What horrifying, terrible affliction can we give Tyr?
I can probably give
the normal character.
I know somebody who could probably give you malaria, lady.
Malaria.
Malaria.
I named my third daughter Malaria.
You have a daughter? Wow, that's kind of gross. You're like, what, 16? That's.
Oh my gosh, I want to stab you so bad right now.
Well, if you kill me, you kill your friend!
Yep.
And then Quip's just gonna put one of his hands up and then just wait in front of him, waiting for him to high five himself.
An added bonus.
Oh my god.
I feel like me and the Pit Lord are going to become really good buddies.
I can...
I can't believe we got a nat 20. Brett, you know those memes I sent you before the game? That's what happened.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Alright, so what's our plan now?
Should we go for the crown? Should we try and free the Pit Lord back at Necropolis?
I care very little for this evil creature.
So do
I. Hey, I'm not a creature. I'm a sentient thing, you jerk.
What's his name?
Strictly mechanically speaking, we're all
Balder?
Balder.
Balder. You may not care for Balder here, but...
I really don't. He poisoned me.
Necropolis High. We have to.
I
think we should go for the crown first. It's just my vote.
Well, if the living... The thing about this is, the city where he says it is closer to you guys than the living city.
Then we should go there.
That means Taj is going on a wild goose chase right now.
Good. Keep it that way.
Do you guys... Wait. The crown. Do you know what it does?
Hold on. Can I do an insight check to make sure this guy isn't lying about this whole thing?
Well, you can't really see his mannerisms. Now he's equipped, so I guess you can. So, yeah, sure.
Would I be able to tell if he's lying or not since he's a part of me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's not. You don't feel he's lying.
Yeah, he's not lying. I can tell.
He vowed. I mean, he's lawful.
Yeah. Is he lawful evil?
Yeah.
I rolled a 7.
Oh.
I still just trust him.
So, what do you
if
know?
Anything... ruse. He could be just pretending to be Quip.
Do you know what this crown does?
It makes one of us a blank.
Well, I think Tyr does, but she doesn't want to tell us for some reason.
Oh, no, I told you.
You're right about the blank part, but that's only part of it.
It's the first step in becoming
What does it do?
God.
It brings you into the vacant throne.
What?
Every council in the Pantheon, there's always a vacant throne that no god sits at. It gives you, lets you enter council with the gods for a single session when you wear it.
God of nothing.
Well, you're the god of nothing. You're the neutral party. It's kind of a curse. If you wear it, you're pretty much trapped there. The reason we call it the Living City was when the first person put it on. He was a powerful mage, and his power brought the whole city to life, but we couldn't get him off his throne.
You guys are going to make me wear it, because if I wear it, you're going to get with me and the Pit Lord. And I don't want to wear it now.
Ooh, if you wear it, Asmodeus would no longer be my boss. That's a promotion I didn't think was possible.
You can't wear it without me, though.
Yeah, that's two neutral parties.
I'm going to high-five him.
We're going to...
My word.
But this is all inside my head.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Oh God, no, he's Brett.
Stupid. Yeah.
Is this where you intended this to go?
Not at all.
The idea was a cabbage that would really work well with Quip.
You did this with Brett!
And then I got Quip to start wanting to go Naruto.
I always like to be as powerful as possible.
Mm-hmm. Oh my word.
Yeah, we've learned that. I remember, my first game I ever played with him, he wanted to create an army of vampire sharks.
How much treasure I also heard that got him killed. The first game I played with him, he got arrested. Anyway,
yeah, that was
a little bit confusing for me.
Anyway,
how much
treasure has Arcus found while we're doing all this talking?
500 gold. He's just swinging it.
Yay! The horde grows.
So, that thing should be kept buried.
What thing?
The crown. Sure, it'd be fun to use, but you don't until it's sealed to you. It's not something you should wear.
I don't understand.
Yeah,
you wear it until you die. Whenever the gods call a council, or a summit, you are brought there as a neutral party.
Right.
Okay.
Those summits can last ages.
Like, how long is ages?
Like, literally lifetimes these council summits have lasted.
So what's the point of getting this crown now?
You become the neutral party. You become a blank, and when you're not in there, and until you die, whenever a summit is called, you sit there, and you are in charge of not leading discussion, but making sure the discussion gets fruit.
Wait, so you see what you're saying is, when there's not a discussion going on, we can, like, go about our lives and try and become a god, but if there is a discussion, like, it pops up, then we're stuck there for hundreds of years.
You're stuck there until it ends, or you die of old age, somebody kills you.
But if you become a god, you wouldn't be a god of nothing, and then you wouldn't be... This doesn't make sense.
No, you're not becoming a god, you're not immortal, you're a blank.
Yeah, but if you do become a god from a blank, wouldn't that not make sense for...
That's the only way to get the crown off without dying, is being a domain.
Oh.
Do the gods also hate you?
Yeah, they try and kill you when you're not in the comet. I mean, you're a neutral party making them compromise. No higher being ever wants to compromise.
So wouldn't, if they wanted you dead, wouldn't they just, like, gerrymander until you died of old age?
That's generally what happens.
Oh.
If it's something important, they stop it, but they'll bring up minor... If they don't like the person, they'll bring up minor matters forever until you die of old age.
That would totally be something Asmodeus does.
Yeah.
Hold the meeting until you die.
But why hasn't anyone killed a god while at the summit, then?
They're not physical there. You can't fight. Oh. You can't leave your chair. If you go to the summit building itself... You can, but gods aren't allowed there. Okay.
Penny, what do you have?
What? She's talking to her dog. So, I mean, you have the info. You could just head back and say, hey, yo, the crown's not there.
But then, just hear me out, Tyr's brother would most likely hear this information somehow.
That it's not there?
Before he finds it.
Boy, quip, guys, quip. Have you ever heard of this wonderful, magical thing? Probably the highest level spell you've ever seen called lying. It's phenomenal.
What level spell is it?
It's a cantrip. You can do it as much as you want.
Okay, but you're also lawful, yes?
Mm. Well... There's a thing called loopholes.
Well, I'm chaotic neutral, so I can lie.
Wonderful! Yeah. We will make a great team.
Yep.
Well, you're chaotic neutral. I said you couldn't be, you asshole.
What? No, you didn't. Wait, what did you say I couldn't be chaotic neutral?
Like, the prince is very upset.
Yeah, I'll yell at him later. But, so... You guys still want to go to the Living City? I mean, that if your brother's there, that city kills people easily.
He can handle himself.
Do you care about that brother, though?
Wait, doesn't... I mean...
actually, at this point, I think I would just rather, like, go back to Necropolis and try and, like, help against the monster and free the Pit Lord and just tell them, like, not to go after the crown.
What was the point of getting the crown in the first place?
Just to get us out of the way.
The idea was it's a quest that nobody completes. Get it, so they give it to people. They give it to you because they need to give out as many quests to save as many lives.
Oh. Right. Okay. Well,
so and the idea of if you succeed, you guys can grant somebody. The school could grant somebody as a neutral party to the gods. Imagine giving an old sage that. That'd be immensely useful.
Could you imagine? But why would the students just be like, why wouldn't they just wear it themselves?
Because the idea is if they wear it themselves, they'll be killed. They don't have the wisdom or the charisma, because they're still students, to be able to keep themselves alive in the council of a god.
Cash is an idiot, but he's an idiot and he's a jerk and he's not very strong, so honestly he's probably safer at the City of the Living, or the Living City, whatever. Mm-hmm. City of the Dead. So just let him do whatever he's doing. Do we want this crown?
The thing is, if they sent us away to get the crown, do you feel... I mean, we could go back.
And now you've got me!
Yeah. But I mean, there may not be a way to get you back into your body, and we may have to keep you in mind. So if we go get the crown, we would have a way to become stronger, and we may be able to get the god's help.
It's not like you could get the god's help, but you, as a neutral party, you're neutral. Yeah. You can't really propose things. Unless a god brings up the terrace, you cannot speak of it.
But, I mean...
It's gods getting their help is almost as difficult as becoming a blank itself.
Is there a way to get the gods to care about the Tarrasque?
They care about it. Last time a Tarrasque was around, it slayed a god. To be honest, they don't want to admit it, but they're scared of it.
Okay, so that might be a reason for them to hold a summit, yeah?
But the idea of you could stop Tarrasque with the crown, but only after Necropolis would be destroyed. You could stop it from destroying the world, but you can't stop it from destroying the city if you use the crown method.
No possibility of us... What happens if we go back to Necropolis?
Well, you guys would probably start having to help coordinate. You'd probably put on soldier duty. Maybe they free the demon. They gain somebody immensely powerful. Who has a direct line to Asmodeus, who may be able to enlist him, and maybe another Pit Lord.
Okay, so the Pit Lord, how many Pit Lords are there?
There's me. I could call up some buddies.
How strong are the Pit Lords compared to the gods?
So, to put in lines of this, there's about 9 Pit Lords.
Yeah.
Each one for a layer of hell. Then Asmodeus rules over all of them.
Okay. I'm just thinking that if this thing can slay a god, and if a Pit Lord's weaker than a god, what help would it really be?
Well, the god was fairly old. He wasn't the strongest. It was a weird situation, to be frank. But what... I think it's somebody who's stronger than pretty much... it's somebody that's equal as strong as the army. You guys, realistically, this Pit Lord's probably would double your army strength.
And he's in me.
Yeah. Like, this guy is a walking... The Tarrasque is a walking global... is a walking nuke. This guy's a walking hurricane.
But...
More powerful, a hurricane or a nuke?
Nuke.
Yeah, nuke.
Oh. Nuke.
Yeah, most definitely nuke.
More collateral damage.
Just straight up.
Yeah, just straight up. But if a hurricane's going to fight a nuke, you want the hurricane on your side.
Can a hurricane, but, like, redirect you?
No, if we had, like, a bunch, what if we had, like, the 9 hurricanes? Wouldn't that...
Well, I mean, 9 hurricanes would probably destroy a nuke.
And hurricanes could probably destroy, like, half of the eastern seaboard.
Well, I mean, that's, like, you know, but...
Look, guys, I may have been here for a couple thousand years. I don't want to... If I wanted to listen to people squabble for 1,000 years, I'd go put on the crown. So, what's your decision? What are we doing?
I mean...
Are we voting again?
Yeah, let's just vote. I mean, either way, we're going to do something useful.
Voting? Is this some you guys are dumb.
You're lawful.
Yeah, he is lawful.
Don't you just obey somebody's orders?
No.
That's
weird. We don't really have a leader.
None of us would be
I'm your leader now.
Oh my gosh.
No, you're not.
No.
Nope, you're not our leader.
Okay, I'm
We're sorry. The leader together.
Oh my gosh, I will stab both of you simultaneously.
No, but... Okay, let's take
a
vote.
Guys, the cabbage just comes out, damn it! Okay, do I get a vote?
Yeah, you can be the neutral party if we need a tiebreaker.
That's actually a really good idea, Quip. I say confusedly, like,
Okay, so I'm going to vote in favor of getting the crown. Sarah, you can go next.
I want to enlist the help of, like, the other demons and try to see if the demons and the demon lord can get rid of the monster thing.
So Necropolis?
Yeah, in Necropolis.
Okay, so Talon, your vote now?
Necropolis.
Wait.
Yeah.
What happens if you die? Do I die?
Most likely.
I don't want to go to Necropolis, and we'll get killed. I can't get out.
3-2. Let's go.
Nat 20, Fred. Nat 20.
Okay. Are we? I'll start calling. Do you think you guys get a cell phone? Let's still use those. No,
hey, listen, we're going to get you out of Quip's body, that smelly, unwashed body, into a fresh Pit Lord body.
Now, what you guys are completely ignoring is there's a scroll of locate person in here, or locate a creature, I'm going to say.
We can use it to see where Tyr's brother is going. Maybe he found out that the crown isn't there.
Or we could just look for the monster, like the Tarrasque.
Yeah, but
well, you know where the Tarrasque is.
Where the Tarrasque is. But if we use the scroll,
track of Taj?
Yeah. What if he's gone to the city?
No, this isn't a one-time thing.
Can we use it to look for this guy's body?
Yeah, you could. The thing is, this isn't a one-time thing. This you can attune it to a person, and it shows where they always are.
Okay.
Oh.
Now.
Oh, can I look for that Leviathan too, if I wanted
to? Yeah,
you
can totally. Yeah, you could. That's actually a quest that Shargoff is on right now to try and find the Leviathan to see if it's active again.
Oh, is Shargoff the boxer?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I really don't want this to turn into everyone gets their own monster.
No, it's not going to be like that.
Yeah. Well, I do.
Well, you know, it would just turn into Naruto.
Yep.
Yeah.
Naruto got really bad.
Yeah, dude, it really did. Okay, but we're heading back to the city?
I mean, I guess so.
This is really confusing for someone who hasn't watched Naruto.
Yeah. Okay.
It's really just...
Basically, it's a monster, which is a demon, and, like, they take over and can fight and are really powerful and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That's so fun.
Okay. 9-5.
Ayubi.
This is just ridiculous at this point.
Yep. Okay, so are we heading back to Necropolis?
I don't really see what else we can do.
You guys want to?
What are we using the scroll for?
You could just book it for later. Maybe something else would be important.
Alright, we'll hold on to the scroll.
Or you could just use it on your bro.
Can we change what we use it on later on?
No.
It's a one-time use, right?
Yep, it's a scroll.
Okay.
Would you guys be opposed?
It's basically a map of the world, and it just you say the name of the person, it shows up, and it shows like a mark where they are.
Listen, I've got a ton of money. We can pay somebody to make another scroll.
Yeah, we could. That's true.
Let's see what Taj is up to.
Yeah.
Okay, you gonna do it?
Yeah, we're gonna do it.
Sure, I'll do it. Where's Taj? Right behind you.
Two marks come up.
Wait, what?
One in Necropolis. Oh, one is moving towards the living city.
What?
And wait. I said we ended there.
God damn it, Brent.
What?
Wait, so are Ollie and Taj the same person then?
No.
Okay.
Where's Ollie? Okay, yeah, let's end it there. Wait, what?
Are there two people named Taj?
No, it's specific. You, the person you have in mind is the person. So, any ideas? Anything you want to talk about?
No, not really.
That got wings good.
That did. Wait. You played right into your hands. You were planning on that the entire time, right?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
The idea was, look, I plot my crap out in advance. I put the creature thing in there. I'm like, okay, here's the people this could help. Here's what... They may just book it, but here's the ideas I have if they happen. Like, the cabbage, though. The idea was you guys would have a talking, annoying cabbage as a pit lord, just nagging you, trying to get you to do his quest the whole adventure.
Now Quick is the talking, annoying pit lord. Yeah.
Oh. It's time to go give Taj a wedgie. Amazing.
Can I talk to the pit lord in my head?
Yeah. It's like Piccolo.
Piccolo? What?
In abridged.
Oh.
Can we watch more of that now?
If we want. Anything we guys want need to talk about? Ideas? Also, you guys, for the roleplay, you get 150 XP.
Yay.
Oh, okay, so what a ridiculous
one
amount.
One second, let's go. Hmm?
30. We only need 100 XP to level up one more.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Are you kidding?
No, we need 300.
Oh, yeah, you guys would get that in a single fight. I'll just give you the level.
Yay!
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're
I'm going to stop the recording here, and we can do post-talk and ideas, or we can do post-talk, what you guys want.
Okay. I don't... You choose Brent or Winters.
Well, let's do a bit of post-talk, you know, coming down from roleplay. You got to get out of the mood, otherwise it's horrible.
Okay.
So, anything we need to clarify, equipment-wise, what you got? Today was, you guys got a lot more XP than I planned.
I took a finger from that skeleton.
Well, okay.
I'm confused about what the ruby skull is.
I really got nothing.
Okay, the ruby skull, think of it as it's a power source. They took a living person's soul, an attack seemingly crystallized the body, and they took the phase and put it in used it to make a golem. All
right. Okay. And now it is on Arcus's treasure pile.
Mm-hmm. So, that pit lord, though.
Oh my gosh.
By the way, are we doing where you can replace ability score improvements for feats or something if you want to?
Yeah, you can.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, we can.
I'll just look through them.
Just tell me the feat.
Wait, a third.
Yeah,
we
take her out. I'm just looking on.
So, also, from now on, you can either take half your hit die or you roll for add con for half.
What, Brent?
You no longer just get max health.
Okay.
You either add a hit die, you either take, like, say you have a d10, you either take 5 plus con, or you roll an add con.
Okay,
we're still live, by the way.
Yeah, I know, we're doing post-doc.
I am going to roll my d6 right now for my hit die.
Okie doke.
And I got a 3, which, perfect. Not really any difference.
That's average.
Yeah, 27.
So, here's the big thing, guys. Actually, no, wait, you're supposed to do it for the first floor. Just take the full hit die, guys.
Oh.
You do it for the first four levels in fifth. Yeah, I forgot. I'm
there you go.
Yeah.
All right, then. 44 HP.
30.
Okay, because if you're still in the 20s by level 4, you're dead. So anything we need to discuss, anything you guys want to talk about or clarify, maybe talk out ideas, just remember I have my notes out if you give me any idea.
I am still a little bit confused about the crown.
What do you need to know?
I'm just confused about why it's the blank and, like, the pit lord. I mean, no, you become a plank.
Oh, I found my old... I've been looking for this map! Sorry, I got distracted. I found my map of the continent of Altheria. It's a thing in this world.
Oh, okay.
It's a different concept. I completely forgot. Okay, back to topic. What were you asking?
You know, never mind. I think
just
I
figured out. No, just ask.
No, I figured it out myself. You know.
I don't like you doing that. I need to make sure you know what it is right, so you're not making wrong assumptions.
So you become a blank and the neutral party.
You become a blank, and whenever there's a summit, you are made the neutral party.
So, it would,
so does does becoming a blank mean that, like, are those two things separate? Like, do you have to be one to be the other?
Yeah, they're separate.
Like, all blanks are...
To be when you become the neutral party, you are made a blank. Just okay. That's the power of the throne itself.
Okay.
But you cannot be a blank and not be a part of the neutral party.
Ooh, I guess.
It's possible to be a blank and not be a part of the neutral party.
Yeah.
All right. So there's other options available.
Yeah. The crown's probably the worst way to do it, just because of that neutral party.
Mm-hmm. Where the heck is Ollie?
Okay, about
no. You didn't check for Ollie, but all you know is Taj is in two places.
Right, yeah. And that's the thing, is that Ollie could be in either place. He could have either gone with... Oh my gosh. He could have gone with Taj, or he could have stayed... No, he probably went with Taj.
What?
There's a fake Taj back at the... disguised as Ollie, and Ollie probably went with... The two of them probably went together.
Why would Ollie go with him, though?
But then you got to think of how accurate is this girl? It's literally linked to a person. If it's a imposter, the imposter's name would still be different in their soul.
Right, right. But Taj is a master of illusions. He probably made a clone of himself.
Well, his cloning that's not cloning.
I mean, if it was a clone,
it
then could
be. It could be. All this is possible.
Oh, I'm so confused. Oh, sorry. Okay, we'll deal with this in character later. But I'm trying to figure out what on earth.
Ooh.
I'll give you props, man. That hit me out of left field.
Good job.
Can we talk about my sick D20?
Yeah, dude, that was a... your idea was... I was actually about to kill you.
I find that... that nat 20 will hit you right when you need them.
Or right when you... or a nat 1. Let's be real here.
Yep. There was so much on that roll.
I'm probably never going to do anything stupid in this game again, just because my ruck has run out.
That's not true.
Well, yeah. Not anything too stupid.
Oh my gosh, it's going to take me 2 weeks to figure out what the heck.
Cool. Oh yeah, next week it's Troika again.
It is.
This is going to kill you.
This week I'm going to be sending you guys some information that your characters know.
Okay.
Because Ryan was all like, that was important information that I did not know, and I should have. And I was all like, you're right.
What? What did you say, Wings?
Oh, because you didn't have certain information that you probably should have.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And I was like, oh, right.
There we go. There we go. So here is my big issue with what I did with the whole Taj thing. I had that plan, but I had a bunch of ways I think to work it out. I always have trouble deciding. I just figured out how I'm doing it. And boy, do I love super high magic settings. I can do anything.
Wow. Well, now I have the opportunity to stab both Quip and a demon.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
At the same time.
Nope, you won't. Because I'm...
Because I'm starting to like you.
Yeah, you know, I'm the lovable idiot.
Yeah, it's true.
So, we're going back to Necropolis?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. That's what you guys want to.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. One of the Tajs is getting a wedgie.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, maybe they're twins.
But they would have different names still.
Oh, yeah.
Taj and Ollie are twins.
Are they?
Yeah.
Which one's older?
But they're not the same person?
I want to say yeah. Taj.
Okay, Taj, that would make sense. The older one's always the asshole.
I don't know. With Brent and his brother.
Wow.
Are you saying Brent isn't an asshole?
No, he is. It's just his brother is...
Older?
Might be worse.
Wait.
Yeah, he is a little older.
Oh, yeah. I don't know Brent's brother. So he can be...
Good.
I have a lot of just shit in my inventory.
Oh, now that I have Arcus, I'm going to, too.
This is going to become an adventure game.
Arcus is literally my excuse to just grab any shiny thing there is.
Okay, so I just wrote down officially what I'm going to do with the Taj thing, so now I won't forget what I'm doing with it. Great.
So is that it?
If there's anything you guys want to talk about.
Nothing related to the game, anyway.
Okay.
Wait, I have a question.
Yeah, what does it do?
How did we get so much XP this session? It didn't feel like we were getting all that much.
Because we've been playing since, like, 4.
Two hard battles.
Yeah.
One battle that was over deadly.
Oh, now I remember the battle.
Check and yep. role play.
Yep, now that makes more sense.
It was also ridiculously long.
Nah, dude, it was about a... We had to take, like, an hour break earlier, remember?
Yeah, my...
And we started forward, and it was just a little above average, actually. So, yeah.
Okay.
So, is that all the questions? Then I'll stop the broadcast.
I think so.
Yep.
I'm gonna see you guys later.